following broadcast is for your eyes and ears only. This is the Joe Cronin Show, and I'm Joe Cronin, and I've got a long one in my pants, and you just watched AEW from Chris Jericho's Rocket Rager at Sea. Who the hell is this hottie? I'm gonna jizz. Joey Janela is appropriating blacks. Hangman Page is drunk. All this and more on the AEW Wednesday Night Dynamite Review on the Joe Cronin Show. Hit the like button if you're not into ass play. We're coming to you live from Boston. Exciting on the wrestling show tonight. Tonight, Jake DeMarco makes his return despite the fact that his tooth is devastated. Jake DeMarco's tooth has been devastated by God. God himself devastated Jake DeMarco's tooth, but he will be back tonight on the Joe Cronin Show. Rockin' Rager at Sea. What's up, chat? How's everybody feeling tonight? Don't forget about the new $21 donation and the new $11.50 donation and the new $11 donation and all those motherfuckers. Here comes.
I fucking love Priscilla Kelly.
Priscilla Kelly, man. Holy shit. First one of the night from Brandon Brown. What's up, Brandon? How you doing, dude? Dude, I had to put that girl on the cover of the thumbnail. I was like, yep, she's going on the thumbnail. Well, that and it was like the first thing that popped up for me when I froze my screen. So I was like, good enough. All right, we'll put her up. Brandon Brown, thank you, Brandon, for the donation, man. What's going on, brother? Hope you've been having a good time here. I've been having a good time. Brandon Brown, that is going to earn you the top spot early on here for the JCS Digital Championship. I'll get that belt over here. So I thought it was overall a pretty good show, man. It definitely, AEW definitely benefited tonight from being in the location they were in. They really didn't get into any weird stories and things like that, which I do like. I like when they have stories going on, but tonight I like that it was just a night of, let's just have wrestling matches and kind of, you know, whatever people's characters are, let's use those and tell wrestling match stories. So I really did like that. I like that there was no bullshit tonight. They'd just done so much of it and it was too much. Tonight was the complete opposite. It was like almost no building whatsoever. So, I mean, yeah, but I expected that. Except for I did really hope that they would do my idea of Jericho crashing, or rather John Moxley showing up on the boat and kind of crashing the party. I really thought that would have been cool. I guess they determined that it wasn't worth it. They didn't want to do it, you know, or they, I don't know. I don't know why they didn't do it. I mean, maybe it was just too much to do, I guess. So yeah, I'm not really exactly sure why that was. I got a big announcement to make, really big announcement to make for Monetize This before we get into this AEW Dynamite review, which we're about to get into. We're going to get into this AEW stuff right now. Jake DeMarco is here too, so that's going to be cool. But check this out. He's fresh off his, tooth ripping, pulling devastation, just horrible shit. This Friday night, Dr. Earl, Five Questions with Dr. Earl, debuts on Monetize This, a new segment on Monetize This. We had Dr. Earl go out and ask anybody he could the same questions. And, you know, every week or so, we're going to get new ones and new people interviewed about them. And this is just a quick little clip I put up on Twitter of one of the first people Dr. Earl talked to. Look at this.
If you're a mass murderer, yes.
Ask her what I was doing.
At Dr. Earl, one of the questions he asked this this lady here is, how would you kill people if you were a mass murderer? It's going to be good. It's coming to monetize this Friday night. It's a really good segment. I think it's going to be great. Dr. Earl is amazing for this. But let's get into AEW, baby. And here he is, fresh off of the Novocaine, the pain in the rain. Jake DeMar. Would you shave your face, too?
Yeah, I had to, get rid of some of the beast. And I'm still all swollen, so, you know. I'm hanging in there, though. My tooth tried to go over the top rope after starting to watch Raw the other night. It was just, yikes.
I can't even imagine. Like, I've never had a tooth pulled. I mean, I can't imagine that's fun. Like, it's
well, it wasn't just pulled. I've had them pulled. It had to be drilled out, too, because of the way it broke.
Ugh.
So I got stitches and all that fun stuff.
Like, they had to drill into it to then pull it out?
Yeah, because it broke, so it wasn't going to come out clean. And because it was the top one, It went and had a hole in my sinuses, so
dude.
I had to stitch that up. And every time I lean straight over, my nose just starts running. It's pretty funny. But
I'm going to throw up on you.
Yeah, the infection was inside the tooth itself, so it wasn't like I bit down on anything and it broke. The infection was so bad that it caused the tooth to split from the inside out, and the infection itself went all the way up into my sinuses, up my jaw.
Oh my God, dude!
pain on a daily basis, and like I said,
it's good. It
didn't
fell out
feel great all day, but all of a sudden I was watching Raw, and I'm like, I feel miserable, and then it just hit me like a shovel to the face. So
it's a good thing it happened then, because you weren't even talking about an infection you had. You just were like, oh, whatever, I've got teeth problems sometimes. Who cares? And then
yeah,
but then going there, the guy was like, yeah, this is like massively infected.
This is awful. Yeah, I showed you the aftermath and x-ray. It's disgusting.
It's probably good it happened then, because that could get way worse.
Yeah, it could have gotten a lot worse. So
you can get in your brain and your head.
Yeah, they said it can cause heart issues like endocarditis and whatnot.
You know what?
I was surprised.
I read that exact same thing. Lots of people said that same thing to me, that like, oh my God, it can cause heart problems or heart. And I was like, what? Why? And I guess because like, would you say like the germs or the stuff in the infection get to your heart somehow?
Yeah, there's that, and then it also changes your heart rate, and it's a whole slew of nonsense, but...
Wow. Dude, that's weird.
But glad to be back and speaking.
Yeah, Jake DeMarco's back, baby. AEW tonight on the... What do you think of the look of the ship, you know, how they had the ring set
up? I thought
it
was great. The setup was very personal, but yet it had this huge atmosphere feel to it, and especially because the 98% male audience that's there,
yeah,
they went ahead and, you know, they're right in the action, so they're chanting, they're singing along to Jericho's theme, you know.
That was cool.
That was great. Everything just had that much of a more triumphant feel to it, so that was pretty cool overall. And I do wish they did a bit more being with the ship. Granted, we got to see MJF go into the pool, which was a cool little moment.
You knew someone was going to go into the pool. I mean, right?
Yeah,
we
pool,
pretty much
hot
knew
tub.
That.
We were going to see something along the lines of that. But I was hoping, I knew realistically they weren't going to be able to have him, you know, come in live on a jet ski. But since they were on the island, I wish they did that earlier, like filmed it as if he was coming in live. Or they, you know, I wish they did more with the environment. It having the wind blow, seeing everybody's hair move, and it just gave it that larger-than-life feel. I just wish they utilized that a bit more than just being there on location.
Right, I agree, yeah.
But it was still fun. I mean, it was a good show from start to finish, and definitely a safer show than what we're used to. There was nothing outlandish here. They really wanted to just give you the best matches as possible, put their best foot forward, and try and highlight the best things they have going on, which is brilliant. You know, that's what they needed. Especially after a few misses that they had with trying to tell wacky, outlandish stories.
Yeah,
so I was happy with, you know,
the
a
weird
really
thing
good
is,
match in the beginning. And
the only thing that drives me nuts is like how last week it was so ridiculous, over the top, and then this week it's so just wrestling oriented. And it's like, why can't we get like basically tonight with a couple stories going on at the same time? That's been the perfect balance. And it's like, we can't, like, just do that almost every week. But, I mean, it is cool that they can one week go to this weird story thing, and then other week they're right back on track with more of the wrestling. Let the wrestling tell the story and just leave that stuff alone for now.
Yeah.
So, yeah, man, it is wild. I'm going to go to the donations now real quick. If you guys want to donate tonight, the link is down below, or Super Chat, whichever way you want to do it. All the donation amounts are listed at the bottom of the description box as well. There's a couple new ones, a new $11 one, new $11.50, and a new $21 one. And there's a new $3.50 one. There's a, I think that's a Drew one. But, yeah, so let's go ahead and pay these bills while we're taking a break here.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh.
It's turkey time.
What if the turkey's here?
The turkey's on the fucking boat.
What if they
He's on the fucking cruise ship with everybody else.
What if they killed us and ate our children? What if the turkeys ate us? What if they filleted us? If the turkeys ate us, if they had to hate us, Thanksgiving was a little bit different. Instead, the turkeys ate us, they gobbled us apart. But first, they'd eat our nuts, and then they'd eat our butt. The turkeys ate us. What if the turkeys ate us? What if the turkeys ate us? What if they ate our fucking nuts? What if the turkeys ate us instead of mashed potatoes?
Look at all those turkeys in the chat right now. Do you understand how many turkeys are blowing up the chat room right now on YouTube? This is nutty. They're all gay.
Great show tonight, 8/10.
Woo!
Sound is still off in places and Tony's face said it all about that promo with Baker. Fucking yikes. BTW Kelly was the chick who did the tampon spot in Impact.
Oh.
Shit still needs work, but that cruise ship looked fucking awesome.
My God, that was the tampon chick, Soundwave 92. Thank you, Soundwave, for the $29. And yeah, man, I mean, Britt Baker, if you're going to be a heel and do a promo, can we do it right? That just was lackluster promo. That it felt like her heart wasn't into it.
That's the thing. She felt like she didn't want to be a heel. She sounded more drunk than angry.
Yeah, she sounded like a drunken bimbo or something.
That was the problem with it.
Tony, what I'm going to tell you is you were just working at Starbucks, right? And now you're lucky to be here. So, and it was like, it just like really, what the fuck, dude? Britt Baker's promo was horrible.
And anyone attacking, you know, Tony is obviously going to get a good amount of heat. So it worked in that regard, but not for the right reasons. It was just cheap heat.
What did he say to her first? Because he said something that was irritating. Oh, yeah, because she cheated, right? So he was like...
Yeah.
He was like, well, not the way you think you'd want to get it done, but you got it done. Oh, not the way you think you'd want to get it done, Tony? Kind of like how not the way you want to be working at Starbucks?
Yeah, he said that what she did was questionable. And
yeah. How about?
He's like, it's not really your character. And she went on immediately. You know, she's like, oh, everyone loves you, but, you know, you had your meal ticket. You know, this was your meal ticket because you were just working at Starbucks. And she said something, but it got cut out, too, because they had to edit down the crowd a lot. The crowd was... rather uncouth, and I'm sure pretty inebriated being on the cruise.
Right.
They were chanting, fuck that boat, and your boat sucks, and because another cruise ship pulled up behind them. Jericho addressed it in the main event at one point, but they were going nuts screaming at the other boats that were pulling up.
That's just hilarious, man.
It was one of those, you know, wild, raucous environments, but it made it more exciting knowing, you know, why. And they were not happy when any other cruise ship pulled up or, you know, into dock. And they were just screaming at him left and right. But the crowd got a bunch of good chant times in, and they were very responsive. And it was unfortunate that they had to bleep it so heavily, though, because not only did it get cut from, like, the regular audio, but because it wasn't separate, since they were doing it remote, the commentary audio got bleeped as well. They had to bleep everything, so...
Yo, I mean, dude, listen, and I understand NXT was probably pretty good, too, tonight. I did not see it yet. We will watch it, of course, as always. Real Talk. What up, Real Talk? Real Talk, the Metaphor Messiah in the chat. Our buddy Real Talk, he's back again. But let me tell you this about Real Talk. He hit me up earlier, and he got all excited about Keith Lee. He's like, I never seen this guy before. What's the deal? Everybody tell Real Talk in the chat how over Keith Lee is right now. Cause
yeah, Keith Lee just won, you know, and huge match tonight.
Yeah, man.
Great on him for winning the North American Championship.
He's got a belt, Real Talk. He's got a belt. Dude,
about
literally.
Time. He earned it. That's for damn sure.
Literally earlier, he hit me up like, where is this guy going to go? And I'm like, oh, he's going to go to the top, man. He's getting a push in NXT. He's going to get there. Then he's going to get somewhere else. And now literally tonight, he wins a fucking belt. He wins a belt tonight. So there you go.
In pretty amazing fashion, too. I'm seeing the end of it right now. And, you know, you've got Undisputed there trying to make the numbers game a huge disadvantage for him. But he's able to overcome the odds and everything turns into chaos. He still prevails.
Yeah, man.
So that's cool. And obviously they're still building towards Worlds Collide as well with Imperium showing up.
I thought it was I thought what I looked at what I saw from NXT tonight was pretty cool. So I can't wait to watch the whole thing. I was watching it, but it was on the small screen. So I really can't give a good, you know, idea of exactly what it was, but whatever. It's the fact is AEW though tonight was a solid wrestling show, and the atmosphere really added to it. Like, let's be honest, man, AEW's atmosphere, and I guess the atmosphere was a bunch of smelly dork guys.
Crowd was so hyped that it made it feel more unique than usual, and that was, you know, a huge payoff for them. This was more of a bash at the beach than last week.
Yeah, well, this
I wish they wait to name it that.
Yeah, this was the bash at the beach.
And like you said, there was no real disappointment as far as matches tonight. There was nothing that was subpar, or there was nothing I would skip over. I could watch this show from start to end again and not be disappointed and fast forward through it.
Just because the wrestling was pretty nice, I'd like to see it again. I don't think there was anything crazy.
No, there was nothing over the top either. Like I said, it felt safe, but. You know, even Baker's promo, I get what she was going for. It didn't have the most passion, but it wasn't horrendous either. It was weird, but it wasn't as abysmal as what we've gotten weeks prior with the Nightmare Collective.
Yeah, I mean, they tried. I just really thought her effort was poor. Like, I mean, really, like, I...
Yeah, it certainly wasn't great. Like, Britt, if you're judging Baker. It on just this show alone, it's going to be docked a few points. But compared to other women giving, you know, promos on the mic... within AEW, that was a 10 out of 10, you know? saying a lot. But.
I just would have, if I was her, I would have been like, really, you're going to question how I win matches now? You're going to question me? The only reason you're here is because you did something good about 30 years ago. You know, I question your dad. I question why you picked out that ugly shirt that you're wearing. You look like a gross old man. How about
that?
And
they used, you know, him actually working as a Starbucks barista to garner heat. And I was like, oh, that's a smart way to do it. You know, you're picking on somebody that had an actual 9-to-5 job. And so you're making yourself feel more elite. Like, I get the sentiment. It just
I win a match and you question it. I win a match and you question it. That's so dumb. But now it explains why you were so dumb. You had to work for Starbucks for all those years. Like, you know, like that type of stuff. It's like, wow. Like,
yeah, and she didn't really cheat either.
She really got into it. Like, yeah.
She didn't cheat, you know. She just was, like, pushing, you know, off the ropes. And it didn't feel like she did anything nefarious. She was just being overly aggressive. He was basically making it sound like, you know, she was underhandedly winning the match. And so I think there was like a bit of a disconnect there too.
Yeah, yeah, it wasn't really a full on cheat. It was kind of
The ref. She didn't, you know, use a weapon. It was just her being a bit more aggressive than usual. She's got potential, that's for sure.
Well, what do you guys think of Britt Baker's promo? I'd like to hear from you guys in the chat. Please let me know. And Keith Lee will not be the number one in the Rumble because Brock Lesnar announced he's the number one in the Rumble. What the hell? Are you on drugs?
Well, some people thought that he might be number two. So
he could be number two.
Number one and number two are basically number one, you know? That's the problem. Yeah. People that number two get slighted because it's the same spot, though.
And now number two is definitely number one because you know who number one is, so it erases that. So
yeah, exactly. So
no doubt about it. Well, you got that right.
There's a lot to cover with the Rumble, but...
Let me run over to another donation here. Take a see who's coming next here. Oh, shit. Soundwave's in trouble with that belt. Soundwave's in trouble.
Tonight we're getting fucked up. Tonight we're getting fucked up.
The metaphor messiah.
Since AE likes utilizing manager slash coaches, I need to see Last Call Scott Hall managing hangover Adam Page.
Whoa. Hazardous beard. Look out for the hazardous beard. He got all kinds of bugs in his fucking beard. Hazardous beard. Thanks for the support on Patreon as well, man. Scott Hall and that cruise would have been awesome. I don't know
having
if they...
Scott Hall trying to bring him to AA meetings and
yeah, well they would
let
had
DDP
a...
save you know that kind of shit.
They would have had to lock Scott Hall like in the engine room or something so he wouldn't drink the alcohol though. That's the only problem. That'd be really tempting. Well, he works for WWE kind of now, doesn't he?
Kind of.
Isn't he sort of like in the NXT thing now?
Even that's odd. I'm not sure, you know, because we never got much clarification with that. So.
Well, Hazardous Beard just took over the digital championship for the night tonight so far. Hazardous Beard.
He snatched that belt away quick.
Right up. Like, right up. One more coming in from the Pac-Man.
$9 for a fuck. Someone donated $9. I'm getting hard. I got 9 inches inside of your wife. $9. I'm shooting my semen to the ceiling. I'm coming and my balls have turned blue.
Suck it, and you can fuck it.
Trust me, Jake, I feel your pain. Toothaches can eat a giant bag of dicks.
Yeah. Hell yeah. The Packer Man, thank you.
Yeah,
$9.
Thank you.
I mean,
tooth pain is awful.
I need about 2 root canals and 2 fillings, and Leah needs a lot of work, too. A lot of work. I mean, on her whole fucking...
So damn expensive. I'm not looking forward to getting that bill.
We all just kind of wait till something falls apart.
Exactly. I'll get that payment plan. Somebody's like, you got to brush more. I'm like, I do brush. It's just years and years and years of vomiting for so long. All my teeth are ruined. I used to have prescription toothpaste for like extra enamel and high sensitivity.
Oh, yeah.
And no exaggeration. Like I can show you the older seats from it. They no longer covered the prescription under my insurance. So to pay for it out of pocket, it was almost $400 for a month's worth of toothpaste.
Yeah, fuck that.
I was like, wait, what?
Plus it gives you cancer.
It's fucking squeeze me? How much?
Plus it gives you cancer.
Yeah, right?
Probably.
What doesn't?
Yeah, everything does. Hazardous Beard is on top, baby. What's up to the chat? Give me your ratings for tonight's show in the chat. What do you guys think? AEW out of 10. What's going on? All right, where else do you want to go with this? I mean, we could go back to the beginning. The beginning match was like 30 minutes.
Right off the beginning, I want to go ahead and get right into it because this is something that I'm thoroughly pleased with for a few different reasons. One, we have new tag champs. So we kind of see the dissolution and disruption between SCU. You know, Frankie kind of ran off into the back. That wasn't really showcased at this point in time, but I'm curious to see what goes on with them. And we've had this build going on for weeks now between Kenny and Hangman. You know, they have this kind of back and forth. They're not getting along, but they're still being able to get the job done in the end. Hangman is delving more into the alcohol side of things. He's not, you know, being part of the elite anymore. He's not celebrating the victories with the other guys. So that's an interesting dynamic. It's a nice slow burn. And now that they're champions, you know there's a point that, you know, he's obviously going to turn. But it makes it even more special that they didn't go through with the usual, oh, we're going to get the tag titles, and then right before we win, I turn on you so we don't win the belts. They actually went through with them having the gold.
Instead, they're going with the WWE angle.
Yeah, and I'm kind of pleased with that because, you know, that's realistic because Hangman, he would want to be champion. Wouldn't you want the title? Couldn't you put aside, you know, your ego and differences because you want to, you know, satiate that thirst you have to become a champion? He wanted the AEW title so badly. Initially, so this kind of works for that. Plus, on top of it, now we're going to see Omega and Hangman take on the Young Bucks, and that's going to be a feud, which is a really interesting dynamic as well. So, I mean, there's a lot of layers here that are building to tell a lot of really cool stories, and I am intrigued. So I give them a full credit here. I'm glad that they didn't rush into anything. They took their time. Because with so many other angles and feuds with AEW, they have just pulled the trigger so damn quickly. Think about it since October. how many matches we've gotten and dream matches and scenarios and feuds that have just been a 1 week, you know, and that's it, 1 week payoff. And I know a lot of that is to win the ratings war. NXT has done the same thing too. You know, oh, we got Finn Balor and Adam Cole. That was instant. Well, same thing here. You know, we've seen Jericho take on a good portion of the roster to defend the title against. And typically you would build that up for months at a time, like they do with MJF and Cody. So I'm glad that they're taking their time and breathing and letting this build up.
How about her, man? How about that hot chick? Holy shit.
Priscilla? Absolutely.
Priscilla,
I love
melt
the red
my
hair.
Life. I mean, that thumbnail came up, like, it, my show paused on that, and I went, well, that's the thumbnail. That's
that has to be the thumbnail.
That's got to be it, man. That chick was smoking hot. Like, I don't really know even what she did in the match, because I was jerking off.
Yeah, Priscilla Kelly, I love the red hair now. That's a great choice.
Well, yeah, that is, I mean, I'm going to fucking die. I mean...
But what do you think about the Young Bucks eventually taking on the tag champs? Do you think that's does that interest you at all? Or
yeah, I think it'd be kind of interesting to see the Young Bucks versus Omega and Cowboy, whatever the hell. What am I, JR?
Cowboy shit.
No, but I mean, I'm like JR. I can't speak. Adam Page. There we go. Jesus. What do you call it? Because sweet chin music, and everybody was like, well, "Wait a minute! No! Super
stop.
Kick party." Excalibur had to tell him, like, no, super kick party. He was like, sweet chin music, which I get, you know, but which is okay. If you say that randomly, I guess that's okay. But the problem is, you know, the Young Bucks, it's a super kick party. Super chat party.
But that's part of their branding and their marketing. So you have to make sure you get that correct.
Yeah. So that was a little, that was kind of funny, but.
Shout
out to the girdles. When Paige told the Bucks we did it before. That rocked me, Joe Cronin, Jake DeMarco, when Paige told Bucks.
Yeah, we did it before you. I agree. See, that was a great bit of storytelling. And they didn't put, like, overemphasis on any one thing for the intro. They really went ahead and, you know, just let everything feel natural, like it was developing in real time. So I was thoroughly impressed, and I appreciate good storytelling. Even if some of the action is shitty, if you have a good story, I'm a sucker for that. You know, I like things to make sense. And to, if I'm emotionally invested, then you've got me. And typically with the Elite, it's more about the high-octane action. So to see them kind of take a step back from all of the, you know, suicide dives and things like that and add more story into their matches, I'm appreciating that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Priscilla was the one that did the whole tampon spot that lit up the wrestling world about a year ago?
Yeah, she took her tampon off and, what, threw it at her or whatever?
No, she put it in the other girl's mouth.
Ugh.
That was the whole...
Yeah, you're right. I remember that. I mean, I remember the whole thing. I just didn't remember what she put in her mouth. I forgot about that.
Yeah, I forget who she was facing at that point in time, but, you know, some of the people were enraged against her for it, but... I forget who she fought at that point in time, but it was funny, you know.
Right.
I think she was facing Tuna, and she gave Tuna the tuna. That was the joke behind.
Oh my god!
But
hell yeah.
You know, in the PG area era, it's good to be shocking every now and again, and not have shock factor be out the window, I guess. But, yeah, I appreciate what they did with the Bucks there, and it was just really an excellent match. The crowd made it feel even better than usual, too. You know, being jam-packed, everyone chanting constantly, it just gave you that huge vibe. And then they were even crowd-surfing Hangman at the end while he was chugging the alcohol, so that was funny.
Mm.
Then we got into Priscilla Kelly, Britt Baker, you know, she's got her own new gimmick as Hell's Favorite Harlot. That's why she's got the red hair. I like the look. I'm a sucker for red hair, redheads all the way. And, you know, we saw them really start to just throw some potatoes into each other. You know, they made it seem a bit more vicious with the clotheslines and the high knees. And we got the near fall with the sling blade. And eventually, you know, you got them towards the ropes at the bottom. and Baker pushes the ropes away, and she gets the lockjaw mandible claw for the win. It was about a 6-minute match, but it was really good. I thought the match was impressive. Obviously, it's not breaking any boundaries here for women wrestling. We've seen better. But as far as AEW goes, like I said, everything previous, this was, you know, damn 5-star match compared to most of the women's stuff we've gotten other weeks. So
at least it was like a straightforward, nice little match. It wasn't anything that was like full of
botches.
There was
no Dr. Luther getting involved. There was no outside interference. There was no stupid storytelling where, oh, this one's trying to, you know, it was just all about the two in ring trying to, you know, have one get over the other. That was perfect. That's what we needed. So that's how you're going to start building up people within the women's division. Straight up matches, tell a little bit of story throughout, and then offer them mic time afterwards. And we said, you know, her promo was a bit of a hot mess, but I understand what they're going for with the cheap heat against Tony being a barista. So
you see that Jerry Lawler won a title in an indie event.
I didn't hear you that.
It was it was career versus title.
Really?
And he's a champion at 70 years old. Jerry Lawler has won the CWA Arkansas Heavyweight Championship.
That's crazy. I am.
What?
You gotta love the world of wrestling, you know.
In some indie, like, oh my god, super chat
party.
It's a sweet chin music party.
Wish John came in on a jet ski. Love you guys.
I know, man.
7/10.
God damn it! I had this great idea, man. Why didn't somebody from AEW steal it? Come on, man. I wanted them to take it. Such a good goddamn idea. Really was. Sorry.
Somebody on Twitter was like, you know, talking to Jericho, asking if he was going to get thrown off the boat, and he's like, "I'll die for real."
Yeah.
Well, you don't need to get thrown off. Just let him ride up on the jet ski, and you're not even on the boat. You're on the island filming, so
can you
let
imagine?
Him pull up on the jet ski.
They're in the harbor. Yeah. Can you imagine if he had rode up on that jet ski with that pirate shit on, with a bat?
That would have been nuts,
dude. That would have been so fun and exciting.
I love that Moxley had that eye patch on for the whole first and second day. Everywhere he went, everywhere, you know, traveling to the Jericho cruise, he's had that eye patch.
Oh, shit. Wait a minute. Good. Oh, my God. It's Kenny Homo Mega.
I think that Omega and Hangman winning the titles will be the perfect setup to having their match versus the Young Bucks. But it won't be for a while, but I have a feeling Omega is the one turning heel, not Hangman.
Whoa.
Also, Darby is a lucky man to be with Kelly.
Whoa. Wait a minute. He's with Kelly? Darby Allin? That's Darby Allin's wife? The redhead?
Priscilla Kelly?
What?
I'm a fucking idiot.
Oh, my God. If that's his wife, then Jesus. He seems like he's an asshole in real life, by the way. Thank you very much to the Soundwave 92. What's up, Soundwave, for dropping the 1150, and he already... Oh, no, he lost the title to Hazardous Beard earlier. I forgot.
Indeed. Yeah, it is Darby Allin's wife, Priscilla Kelly.
Wow. I want to see that porno.
Yeah, right? Red hair and the face paint.
I'm a sick bastard, okay? I'm a sick bastard. How about Joey Janela tonight? Looking a little pudgy. Looking like he drank a lot of beers before the match.
Yeah. I get, because they were trying to put more of the heat on MJF, so they really slowed down Janela overall. They just wanted him there to sell the old school heel bit that MJF was going for.
I thought it was nice. I liked it.
It wasn't a bad match. It was just it's different than what you're used to with main event Janela. You know, usually he's like a rocket shot out of somebody's ass, just nonstop 0-60. And I even really like what they did with Aubrey in that match, because that's super sympathetic. You know, Aubrey, the crowd goes nuts for her. She's beyond over as a female ref.
She's so... I'll tell you what, she irritates me now.
Really? See, yeah, I think she's great. It's not just because she's female. You know, she's a great referee, and
yeah,
I've enjoyed her. You know, and you get a lot of, especially this is going to sound terrible, but you know it's true. The Jericho cruise is definitely part incel on the waters. So they're all about white knighting the honor of, you know, Aubrey. So when you saw MJF kind of use her as a shield, they went ballistic. I feel like that was one of the bigger pops of the night, honestly. If you go back and you really listen, people went ape shit when they went ahead and he put his hands on her. So that was pretty amusing.
Yeah, it worked. I mean, I mean, people like her. I'm not saying. I definitely agree. I like her, too. It's just that there's a part of me that doesn't because I'm irritated by all the Aubrey's the referee. I was like, all right, I get it. Jesus Christ.
And I know they were trying to keep the story going with Sabian and Penelope, but I felt like that was unnecessary for this because you already had so many layers to it with Aubrey and MJF doing the, you know, the real heavy heel shtick here. I don't feel like they needed the distraction, but I get what they're going for because they want to keep everyone focused on Janella and Kip Sabian having that feud with Penelope Ford being the ex and kind of the love triangle thing. So, but I feel like MJF kind of saved it here, especially afterwards. Like, it wasn't a bad match, but it wasn't all that I was hoping for. And MJF being on the mic afterwards, you know, I am a chapter and I'm the last goddamn one. And he was great taunting the crowd when Cody came out and the fans are just berating him with swears, chanting asshole. And that's when the Young Bucks come out and, you know, Cody's, I can't touch you, but they can. They throw him into the pool. And I loved all that. So great, great payoff for the heel to get his comeuppance.
It was, I liked it. I liked it okay. I liked everything. Thought everything was a nice little 7 out of 10 tonight.
Yeah, Jericho and Santana Ortiz with Hager in the background taking on Jurassic Express. You know, everybody had their moment to shine, and you had Jungle Boy taking Ortiz down with that Hurricane Rana. That looked good. Luchasaurus just clears house, and you get the choke slams on Jericho and Ortiz. And then he got this really great standing moonsault, and I was like, damn, he got some height off of that. I was thoroughly impressed by that. Then, of course, Hager gets involved and hits Luchasaurus from behind. So they're really building towards that match. So that's, again, something that I appreciate. More storytelling, more building for rivalries and feuds and having things develop further. That I'm hoping we get sooner than later. I don't know when Hager is going to be actually able to compete, though. We haven't heard anything about him actually being able to get in ring. He's been doing these spots since AEW, you know, had him debut, but unfortunately with his MMA career taking, you know, front and center attention, I don't know when he's going to actually be able to have his wrestling debut in the company.
Seems like at least a month away from it, whatever it is.
I was hoping we would get it at Revolution's pay-per-view and see him take on Luchasaurus. I think that's a big money match for those two, but they did a good job, again, with the Judas effect, making that look devastating. They're really protecting that move, it seems like, lately. And, you know, Jericho celebrates after the victory. He got a little bit of the bubbly on the ramp. Crowd still singing the theme, going nuts. So it was a really cool moment with him celebrating with the audience. And it's funny how when Jericho's in the ring and everyone's singing, you know, the Fozzy theme, you see him try not to crack a smile. But how, even as the most dastardly heel, you have to be kind of honored in that moment.
Oh, yeah.
To know that not only are they singing your theme song, but it's your band's theme song that you sang, you know? So there's like so many levels to that. It's a really cool feeling, I'm sure.
Right. Because you're not necessarily in front of like, you know, a Fozzy crowd or something like that.
No, exactly. So that was a really cool thing to see.
It's a damn good song, man. It's a really good song. Like, I mean, it, wrestling entrance-wise especially.
Oh, it's a great entrance theme, and it's one hell of an earworm. That chorus gets stuck in your head instantly. It's basically on repeat from there.
What an amazing job, man. If he didn't come out with that, like, we would have been like, oh, his old wrestling music was better. You know, this is really good shit. Like,
yeah, he always had a great theme, but this one takes the cake.
That song,
and it's
fire.
Even better that he made it. You know, it's his creation. So,
right.
Then we go ahead and after the pool thing with MJF, we get kind of a interview. Well, we get a video package where they're talking about the comedian there, Fluffy. What's his name? Gabriel Iglesias.
Iglesias.
He shows that, you know, Fozzy on the Jericho cruise, and they let people see what's going on there. I would love to be there. It looks like everyone's just having a great time. And Tony interviews the new tag team champions in the back, And, you know, obviously Paige is still partying hard, getting drunk. And Tony cuts him off, asking about Pac challenging him to a rematch. And this is where Omega says, we're still going to get the rubber match. Then the Young Bucks show up to celebrate. And this is when Paige went ahead and said that, you know, we won the belts before the Bucks. And I was like, damn, that's a great line. Fuck you, boys.
Yeah, fuck it. Yeah, that's hot, man. And then, you know, Paige getting interrupted in the interview, like getting annoyed by it.
Yeah.
Like setting that up was kind of interesting. I'm like, oh, wow. Because I thought for a second I started thinking they're going to bail on this whole thing up until they have a fight with each other. And now they're going to have a big program together coming up later. You know, Omega and Hangman Page, they're going to have the whole best friends turn on each other. Just fucking crazy, you know what I mean, feuds for like a while. It feels like, but, you know, I don't know if that's going to happen, but it seems like that's what they're setting up to me.
Yeah, it certainly feels that way, so. Then we get the main event, and a lot of build to this main event. I mean, obviously, you get the introductions for Jericho again.
Testicle
then
festival.
We go ahead and we get Pac to come out. Then we have Moxley finally come through the crowd. Now we've got about 20 minutes left, maybe about 18. And Jericho was great on commentary, but unfortunately they had to, one, break things up with the commercial breaks, and two, with them muting the crowd constantly, because I guess this is when the other boat pulled up, according to the spoilers. So, you know, you obviously see the crowd chanting something and they keep muting them, but the crowd chanting fuck your boat and fuck all that stuff. So they had to keep cutting the audio. And, you hear Jericho talking to Moxley saying, give up, you stupid son of a bitch. And then it's just dead silence for a good 10 seconds. So it's unfortunate that they had to keep muting everybody. But it was a bit odd at one point. It looked like they kind of didn't know what they were going for in the middle of the ring. We saw like them kind of dance around for a little bit and then both laying down, the refs talking to them. But
right.
You know, they tried to play it off by saying that, oh, that's the elbow that Moxley had surgery on. So it seemed like he was just trying to recover. But it feels like they changed a few moments in the match. So, you know, we saw the Brutalizer get locked on and Moxley ends up reaching the ropes with his foot. And then a little bit later, we get a version of the Paradigm Shift and Moxley wins. Now he's officially, again, the number one contender for the AEW title. And Jericho, you know, stands at the announce table with the belt over his shoulder, basically mouthing off. So you knew, obviously, that Moxley was going to win the number one contendership there. Yeah. I was kind of hoping that wouldn't have been the case, though. I wish they would have subverted expectations and kind of screwed Moxley over one more time to have a bit of a story to build towards Revolution.
Yeah.
Because now we have the match, and we've got a month and a half to get there. So. Or a month and a week, really.
Yeah, like, one of the other things they could have done is, like, stopped Moxley from getting on the boat to compete in his match. And that could have been what happened earlier on, is, like, we've been waiting all night. Moxley's not on the boat.
Now so that's when he has to take the jet ski.
Yeah, so, like, you know, like, they're like, you know, if, oh, did we happen to leave before Moxley found his ticket that he made a mistake and, like, they couldn't find, you know, whatever. And then, you know, Pac is going to be going to the ring, and if Moxley's not, you know, going to have a count of 10, but he's not on the boat. It's kind of academic right now. I mean, and, you know, then that's when tries to get on the boat, and, you know, then Jericho goes down to try to stop him from even getting on the boat. You know, then he fights his way on and then beats the shit out of Jericho and then gets to the ring for his match and has his match and wins just in time for, like, you know, Jericho to make his way back up to the top deck to see him win the match, you know, that thing. Or they could have jumped him in the match and still prevented him from winning even though he got on the boat.
Yeah.
Whatever, but that would have been great.
I just feel like, you know, this being the end to the quest for him to get to the feud, to the you know, title match, what are they going to do? I mean, we've seen so much of a build-up to will he join the Inner Circle that now how many more antics can we see in the ring between these two before we get the title match? I mean, we've gotten the spike to the eye and the attack with the champagne bottles and, you know, everything that they've done to build just to him being the number one contender. Now we've got five more shows, essentially, until we get to the Revolution pay-per-view on Leap Year, you know, day. Right. That's a lot of TV time to cover with basically, are you going to have 1 week be a contract signing? Okay, then what do you do for the other 4 weeks? So yeah. if Moxley didn't win here, I feel like it would have better serviced this feud. Because then he could have had to have another match with Pac, and they could have made it, you know, that was a no DQ, no holds barred kind of what they did with Omega. You know, let it ramp up and build. But I'm still, you know, on board. I'm just That's curious right, to nice see where things. They're going to go from here. So not a terrible development by any means, but nothing overly exciting or next level. All in all, I'd give the show top to bottom like a 7. You could even say 7.5 since the wrestling was really, you know, on par.
Yeah, I'd probably go, I guess I could go a 7.5 on this one. I mean, it was nice. But I honestly, I don't know, man. I feel like they could have, if they did that one or two little extra things, I would have given it a really good score. But yeah, I'm somewhere around a 7 tonight. So, I mean, whatever people want to say in the chat about their ratings, I saw some of them earlier. Love to see what you guys think. Let's go check out some more donations coming in to keep us fed and the bellies full of cum. Sorry, I have no idea what that has to do with
anything.
Why did I say that? Yeah, yummy. $11 donation, Drew's yummy. Ladies and gentlemen, Matt the Misfit. Old school.
You want to play a game? You want to play with Ryback? Gurgle, gurgle, gurgle.
DIY vs. Mustache Mountain has match of the year written all over it on Saturday. I can't fucking wait for that match.
Yeah, that'll be a good one, man. DIY Mustache Mountain. That's gonna be Can't fucking wait. Awesome. Yeah, Matt the Misfit, thanks for the $4, dude. We got another one coming in.
It's me, Ryback. Do you want to play a game called My YouTube Fucking Channel Blows? Yeah,
actually, it's pretty fucking funny. But thank you, Matt the Misfit. I can't wait, brother.
Gurgle, gurgle.
$9 for a fuck. Someone donated $9. I'm getting hard. I got 9 inches inside of your wife.
Resident $9. Evil.
I'm shooting my semen to the ceiling. I'm coming, and my balls have turned blue.
I hate WWE versus AU people. I just want good wrestling, and right now NXT and Dynamite are the best shows out there, so just enjoy them. Excalibur fucking sucks. Give me more Tony Storm, yummy.
Tony Storm, man. You like that Tony Storm? Not that big a deal on her. She's okay.
I like Tony Storm.
I mean, I like her, but
I've enjoyed her in NXT UK, and her and Rhea's feud has been damn fun to watch, so.
Yeah, I like her.
She's young still. I feel like her, Rhea Ripley, you know, they still have a lot to advance with and prove, but
people are saying
they do have a lot of damn potential.
People are saying Balor was good tonight on NXT. Is that real? Really, he really was?
I've heard that as well. I didn't see the match that he had with Joaquin, but because he was facing Joaquin Wilde, so.
Well, we're going to check it out.
Even as a heel, you know, you still hear everybody chanting, "Let's go, Finn." I know this is an AEW show, and we have a ton to talk about tomorrow with the Royal Rumble and Worlds Collide and everything coming up this weekend. But one thing I wanted to kind of strike while the iron is hot and kind of get your side of things and what you think your opinion is. Did you hear about Vince McMahon and Pat Patterson allegedly causing problems at Rocky Johnson's funeral?
Yeah, but then I heard about who told the story, and I went, oh.
That was the thing. So I guess the first one to say all this stuff was Billy Graham.
Yeah, superstar Billy Graham, who's sometimes
not the most credible.
Well, he hates Pat Patterson, too.
He does. And I mean, some other people had since spoken out and kind of backed up what he said.
Yeah, I mean, you'd hate Pat Patterson, too, if you saw him rubbing a kid's ass.
Exactly. So, I mean, there's a lot of reason to have bad blood there. And I guess the preacher spoke for a long time on the podium, you know, paying honor to Rocky. Right. And basically from what I'm reading here, it said the preacher spoke for more than an hour and was very negative towards wrestling as a whole.
What?
So he treated, it says this is you know, not a direct quote, but I guess their attitudes were more against the preacher because he said that wrestling was a fake joke and he was just very negative towards wrestling.
Why would the fucking priest say that?
You know, originally the funeral proceedings were supposed to take place in a much smaller place in front of only about 100 friends and family, and it was moved to a massive church. There was a lot of people there, and this preacher went on and on for a long length of time and was very harsh about their livelihood. So when what? Vince and Pat got up there, I guess, you know, both this is all allegedly, you know, but from what I'm reading, apparently they were inebriated and Pat was swearing, saying shit and goddamn and things like that. And it led to him getting, you know, taken off the podium. Same thing with Vince. So they, out of nowhere, Patterson goes into a rant.
This can't be real.
He said he called Rocky Johnson a motherfucker and started this vulgar rant about how worthless Rocky was. And people came up to the podium and dragged him off the church platform and sat him down.
Pat Patterson?
Yeah, that's what the original accusation was.
Another thing of the Rocky of the Potable motherfucker. Like, I can't.
To see it happen at a wedding, but I guess they were this. So irate with how the preacher was that was their mindset. So by the time they got up there, they were already agitated and inebriated. And that led to them saying horrible things about Rocky. To the point where they had to get taken off the, you know, the speaking platform, so forced to sit down, and then they were dragged out.
This sounds so fake. The priest was saying bad things about wrestling and everybody, and then Vince and Pat Patterson were saying bad things about Rocky. Like, I know. Like, this can't be real. Like, this just, who the fuck came up with this story?
And that's the thing. So Billy Graham was the one to originally, you know, make headway with this. But then it says here that the Johnson family are not upset about it. Al Rosen, who spoke at the funeral, told him that the Johnson family was not offended by anything Pat Patterson or Vince McMahon did at the funeral. So they said that nobody in the family was offended by Vince's behavior. So let's just make that clear. The family was not offended at all by Vince's speech. It sounds like he strutted on and off, but Vince is a character anyway, and he made jokes, so the family wasn't offended. So it seems like people that aren't accustomed to wrestling as a whole or understand Vince and Pat Patterson's way of speaking took things harshly. You know, that'd be like me being like, oh, Joe was one bad motherfucker. You know, he was a son of a bitch. Your fans would get it. But people that don't, you know, your family might be upset because they're not in with the lingo. I don't know a better way to represent that, but. But when you originally hear, like, Vince and Patterson making a huge deal at the funeral, you're like, Jesus Christ.
Right.
It just sounded so surreal.
What day did Rocky Johnson pass away? Was it the 17th or the 16th? Wasn't the 15th, was it?
Let me double check here. It was the 15th, yes.
What a piece of shit this person is. Some fucking asshole on YouTube uploaded, like, people dancing with a casket and called it Rocky Johnson's funeral. But, like, this is not Rocky Johnson's funeral. But they obviously uploaded it to, like, get views.
Yeah.
What a fucking piece of shit, cunt, fuck, whoever this
person is. That's like that J-Station guy. That's the kind of shit he would do, you know?
Dude, like, and someone was like, maybe this is someone else's funeral. It's like, no, it isn't, because they wouldn't have uploaded that same day, and it wouldn't be, like, old footage like this. This is, like, a 2011 or 2007 quality.
Yeah, handheld cam.
In 4:3. Like, what a fuckhead that person is. I hope that video fucks them over. What a piece of shit.
You're also seeing now, since AEW had their TV deal extended to 2023 at least. You know, we know that's definite till then, and we'll see what happens at that point, but the WWE locker room has been a bit more confident to ask for time off and leniency with things, and Vince has become much more agreeable knowing that he doesn't want to have, you know, not an uprising, but, you know, a bad morale in the back. So he's working with superstars to give people more time off. And that's kind of what's needed, because you can't have an off season for wrestling. Obviously,
no.
It doesn't cater to the way the you know, the platform works. But having people kind of work their way in and out, you know, to get a month off a year, I don't think is a problem. You can set up storylines to have it work out that way.
Right.
So.
Yeah. Like,
and that's enough to get people to recharge their batteries and be energized and start enjoying working all over again.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty cool, man. It's pretty wild that we got this announcement this quickly, too.
Yeah,
we did not
absolutely.
Expect to get
it's
this.
It's only been, you know, a few months at this point in time.
Yeah, man. This is really good news for AEW. It's good news for us because we want to be here every week reviewing it, because it's given us a burst of energy to these shows, man, because WWE was so dead for so long. Let me give the credit, man. Again, Hazardous Beard is the largest donation of the stream so far. So shout out to Hazardous Beard. Today is Shy God's birthday in the chat. What's up? Happy birthday, Shy God. Happy birthday, you big fuck. I can't believe it. Oh, my God.
Testicle
happy
festival.
Birthday.
And a happy testicle festival to Drew.
Testicle festival.
Testicle festival. What was that, Leah?
Oh, my God. Die.
All right. My wife said to die. Let's go to the next donation, see what people are saying. Good God, it's going to be Kane. My name is Kane, and I'm donating. I liked AEW tonight, pretty much.
Joe and Jake.
Yo!
What bar is Priscilla Kelly? Ill start. She is a Kit Kat dark chocolate.
Whoa, Priscilla Kelly was looking hot as shit tonight. And guys, a new segment, What Bar? First of all, What Bar? Thank you, man. What's up, What Bar? Priscilla Kelly, holy shit. There is a new segment coming to monetize this. Are you guys ready? Friday night, we debut it. Every week, Dr. Earl is going to ask people 5 questions. And we're going to have to guess at what their answers are going to be. And this is one of those little clips from Dr. Earl. It's going to debut Friday. I haven't even seen it. The new segment with Dr. Earl. Dr. Earl Brown in his new segment here on the Joe Cronin Show. Well, actually, technically, it takes place on my other channel, Corrupted Nation. Monetize this Friday night, baby. It is a new segment. Listen to this. If she was a mass murderer, how would she kill people? And there's a bunch of different choices. I wonder what she's going to say. I wonder what she's going to say. But it's going to be interesting this Friday night with Dr.
Can't
Earl.
Can't wait to see that.
Oh, man. Dude, one of the questions, the last question that Dr. Earl asks everybody is if they think I'm hot. And if it's a guy, he shows them Leah's picture.
Oh, there you go. Really push it.
Yeah, so we're really going to have some fun. What do you think? Do you think she's going to think that I'm hot?
Has to.
Really? You think she's going to say that I'm hot?
I think so.
We're going to find out Friday night on Monetize This on Corrupted Nation, my other YouTube channel. 11,000 subscribers. Come on over there. That's where Monetize This now is. It's no longer here on the Joe Cronin Show. It's over on Corrupted Nation. Make sure you guys sub over there if you want to get involved in that shit. What Bar?
Pocket Aces says Earl's going to get arrested. We'll see.
We did. I did tell Earl, make sure that they're all 18. Everybody's going to be of age. You know, they got to be
willing participants.
Willing participants. Get the ID. They got to be ID'd. So Dr. Earl is really taking some steps there, man.
Yeah, don't take any liberties, though. We don't want to see him, you know.
As long as they're 18, I said, Dr.
Bail
Earl.
Money.
And, of course, it's like they were... I don't know what's up with Dr. Earl, man, but just the black chicks love Dr. Earl, man.
They're all about the doctor.
Here's this big dude with a giant black fro, but he's a white guy, and he looks like a mass murderer himself. Dr. Earl does.
But he's not threatening, you know? That's what it is. Once you start talking to him, they're just like, he's the Jolly Green Giant.
Yeah, man. And Tommy's going to be doing it for us, too. It's going to be crazy. We're going to be competing with Dr. Earl and Tommy and anybody.
Tommy's the one that'll... get some law enforcement interest.
That's good. Yes. Yeah.
That's Onision levels of harassment there.
Imagine if Tommy gets arrested before Onision does.
I saw you put it up on Twitter. You retweeted it, but Tommy sent me that this morning of him with his pants falling off with that TikTok.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, at least we know you're losing weight, you know?
Yeah. If people didn't see it, Tommy's pants went whoopsie. It was today on Twitter.
I died laughing with that. I was like, well, at least you're seeing some payoff and some benefits to all that working out.
By the way, it's disgusting. Let's just
shaking it till he makes it, baby.
Like, who does that? Like, who moves their body like Tommy did?
He's got that flow, you know?
Yeah, nobody sees it, so it's okay to show, but it's like...
No rhythm.
Oh!
It cracked me up.
Oh, man. He looks
Tommy.
Why? Like, he's got a trench coat on. He's got this red shirt on. He's got a hat that's covering his eyes.
Covering his eyes. That was the part that stuck out to me.
I mean, what the fuck is he doing?
That was the one thing that, like, stood out. I was like, all right. He's trying to blind himself in the process.
Looks like a fucking egghead penis.
That's the girdles.
I'm so excited. He's like the hippo guy or whatever in Mike Tyson's Punch Out, and just punch him right there in his belly button. And then, boo!
Fried chicken and foot massages.
Oh, my God, man. What a mess.
And then we see that, obviously, we know already that Brian Cage is going to be joining AEW soon. I mean, that was a huge, major signing. But then Sports Illustrated was talking before today, earlier, a few hours ago, that Lance Archer from New Japan is in talks to join AEW as well.
Oh, really?
That's a huge grab for them. So he won the IWGP United States belt earlier last fall and did really well in the G1 tournament. So, I mean, that's a huge bit of credibility, you know, boost for them to get him to come over. So, and they're really trying to push a working relationship with New Japan. And I feel like that'll only bolster that further as well.
Yeah, that could bridge some gaps, man. They got to just...
But he is, you know, obviously hell of an athlete. He's massive.
It's a big name, man. And we're finally going to get this
him
cage
Him and Moxley
match.
With that Texas death match was good. It wasn't, you know, mind-boggling amazing, but I thought it was entertaining.
Yeah, I enjoyed that. Everybody, I don't know what that negativity. I love what they did. I hope they do more of that stuff. I'm really concerned.
Well, that's why I would like to see him in AEW, because I feel like he can have some really great feuds with people like Moxley, with Darby Allin, because Darby Allin, you know, is a sadistic bastard looking for punishment. That would be a hell of a matchup.
Do you think you're going to get the cornhole virus?
I hope not, but it's a possibility.
Somebody in Washington got the cornhole virus again, like, or the first person in Washington.
It's spreading quickly.
It is, like AIDS or like herpes. My mother has that.
Mine too.
Picard is tonight.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if Picard's at midnight or if it's at 3 a.m. my time. Does anybody?
I think it's 3 a.m.
Oh, man.
Midnight.
So I don't know if I can sleep tonight because I'm going to be...
Midnight West Coast.
I know.
I'm not positive about that, but when I was, they responded to somebody on Twitter.
Yeah, yeah.
CBS All Access, and they made it. It was very confusing by the way they said it. So.
Oh my God.
I'll double check again, but I saw somebody talking about it.
So potentially, what I may do if I can't sleep, which I may, and listen, I know people are going to make fun of me, but here's the deal. And listen, it may be terrible. Picard may be horrible. Picard may be in an agenda-filled. Not Star Trek, horrible show, I don't know. But I am such a TNG fan that I don't think I'm going to be able to sleep. So probably what I may do is watch NXT after this review. And then after I watch NXT, I may go live again with the NXT review and just break down NXT and talk about it and compare the two shows. And that will, you know, kill some time for me to get to Picard. Or, you know, I'll just go to bed like normal and...
Yeah, 3:01 a.m.
Oh, my God. Why would they? Why are you doing this to
it
me?
It says
CBS.
It arrives on CBS All Access Thursday, January 23rd at 12:01 a.m. Pacific, 3:01 a.m. Eastern. Make sure you click on the trailer they have there, play it, and then refresh it, and that'll give you, you know, that'll be the playlist for the episode. So,
well, let's go ahead and take a phone call. We can only take one because Skype is broken, so we can only take one phone call. That's how it's been for a while now, so I hope it's a good one. 734, hello.
Hello, Joe.
Hello.
How's it going?
I only have one question because it's been pretty impossible to keep up with their content lately, but is Brock Lesnar still number one? I only ask because I'm a part of a bet every year.
Oh, yeah. He's still number one.
Okay.
Yeah, he is still number one.
How do you think that's going to play out?
I mean, I said it the night that he announced it. I basically think there's going to be a big gimmick this year at the Rumble, and I think Lesnar's going to get in the ring number one, and I think Lesnar, there's only two things that are going to happen. I think the first thing is the one that I went with originally, which is that Lesnar is going to dominate. He's going to throw out like fucking 18 people or whatever. Like, he's going to throw out like 20 fucking
break
people.
Break the record.
And the last 10 people will be real heavy hitters. And I believe the person that wins the Rumble will be a person that we didn't know was in the Rumble. So it'll be a surprise person. We didn't know they were in the Rumble. That's the person that's going to win the Rumble, and he will get eliminated. But Brock Lesnar will basically make 80% of the Rumble meaningless because he'll throw out almost everybody. That's number one.
Edge is emphatically saying that he's not part of this Rumble.
Like, which is really weird.
He said he hasn't been to Phoenix to be cleared for anything in ages. Last time he was there was years ago to get his wrist fused.
I agree 100% with everything you said, Joe. Wish me luck on my bet this year. That's all I got to say. All
right. The only other thing real quick is that Lesnar would get eliminated immediately by whoever comes in the ring.
That is another
alternative. And I'm not sure if I want to go. I don't know if I want that number one pick.
Think about it. Those are both things Vince would do. The other one would, you know, create that tension throughout the whole Rumble. The second thing would be like a shock. You think here he is entering number one, and he gets taken out almost right away. You'd be like, "Whoa!"
Or Lesnar prevails. He goes from number one, clears everybody, and
yeah, that
right.
That's
Vince's
that's
kind
tale
of what
too.
I'm. Yeah, that's yeah. what I wish would happen, but
really,
I'm not solid on that.
So he's already the champion.
I would love that.
So he's already the champion, and then he clears everyone, and then he can fight for the other belt. Is that that's man? I don't know. I'd be furious.
Yeah, I think.
I don't.
Yeah,
he wouldn't
totally
fight for the other
Lesnar.
Belt. He would just. His story. He's not going for the other belt. His story. He would just win the Rumble. His story is that there's no one there to face him.
Wow.
So then they'd have to have somebody built to face him.
So
after the
Rumble would be a waste.
Yeah, which is a huge worry.
Oh man, I'll put a bullet
in
my head.
That's
on that
why
one.
This year for the Rumble contest that I do each year, I am bringing it back. So all you have to do when I put the video out, you leave a comment down below in the video. And I will assign you a number randomly. It's generated through a program that I have. So it'll give you a number between 1 and 30. And then whoever comes out at your number, so let's say, Joe, you got number 1, it's Brock Lesnar, and you win, then you get a prize pack. So I've sent people some cool stuff throughout the past years. People have gotten video games. They got a Brock Lesnar gift set, different stuff throughout times. But this year I wanted to see, what do you think? I wasn't going to do the men's rumble. I was going to have it be the women's rumble because I feel like with the men's rumble, it's going to be unfair if you get a number in the teens. I feel like that is almost like a death sentence.
Well,
this is where the women's rumble, I could see someone getting a number like 12 or 15 and still having a pretty equal shot. But with the men's rumble, I feel like if you're not number one or number 30, you're not going to have a good time. So I don't see someone at 12 or 15 to win.
The teens are a death sentence.
For the men's rumble, yeah. I feel like there's pretty much however they play it out. Like Joe said, there's pretty much three options. One, Lesnar start to finish, so number one wins. Two, surprise entry, so number 28 through 30, there would be, you know, that surprise. More than likely it'd be number 30. Or three, you know, Lesnar gets eliminated early and someone at the end still wins it. So I don't see anyone from like numbers 10 to like 22 having a shot winning in the men's rumble.
I would agree, but then there's some of those years you never know. You know, you don't want to have no picks in the teens because
yeah, but other times, I mean, I think Nakamura won from like 11 or 12, and another year, you know, so we've had it where we've seen people win from the teens twice actually the past few years. So it's definitely happened. I feel like this year though, it's almost like a given that won't happen. So I think I'm, instead of doing it for the men's rumble, I'm going to change it up and have the pick'em contest go for the women's rumble. But I wanted to see what you thought about that, Joe.
I'm going to sign off. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Thanks for calling, man.
Great call.
My computer was freezing during all that. I was trying to figure out what the hell was going on. I miss what you said.
Basically, I just went for the lottery. I think it's more fair essentially to do it for the women's Rumble than for the men's.
Oh, yeah. No, I think that's a good idea. And, in fact, the women's is more mystery to it in a way to me. And we don't even know. I mean, there's been zero build to the women's Rumble, it feels like.
Yeah, Charlotte was the first one to announce her entry, and there's only been a few females that have said, I'm going to be in the Rumble.
So Friday will probably be heavy on the women because there's no hype for the women's Rumble.
Yeah, there really hasn't been much of a build, unfortunately. For the men's, I think there's 23 entrants already confirmed.
For the men's?
In total?
Yeah, there you go. So that means,
I believe it's 23 right now. So, I mean, all in all, it seems like that's the way to go. So when I put that video up, just go ahead and comment down below, and I'll assign you a number. It just makes watching the Rumble that much more fun when there's something on the line. So
I hate the Rumble because there's no 69. And that's my,
there is no 69. The number.
I want that number, God damn it.
Even with the greatest Royal Rumble, there was no 69. We got up to 50. So close.
I am going to take phone calls in a little bit, guys, so anybody can call and say whatever. We'll talk about whatever. I mean, my final thoughts are that AEW was good tonight, solid 7. I'd watch it if you haven't watched it. If you're coming from NXT and you missed AEW, I think you should watch it. It was a title change. It was a good show. I mean, I guess that's a spoiler because there was only... Well, not really, because you don't know. But yeah, watch the show. It's good.
I'm curious to see how this plays out with everyone knowing the spoiler. Not everyone, but you know, majority of people that would have watched live. I mean, typically I'll watch AEW and I'll go back and watch NXT afterwards. Tonight I still didn't do that, surprisingly enough, but I could have because I knew the spoilers for AEW. So had I not been doing the review, I would have gone and watched NXT and gone back and watched AEW afterwards. So I wonder if that's going to play into the ratings at all since it was a taped episode.
Yeah, it may a little bit. I would think they would go down a little bit. But I think there's also a big interest in the fact that it's on a ship and a cruise. So
yeah, being with the island. And
yeah, and people.
It was crazy that they had to take the Masters tapes and they flew them on two separate planes back to Georgia to get it put in through TNT.
That's pretty crazy.
That's hilarious. They're saying next year that, you know, they're trying to get it so they could do it live from the ship. Cody was talking about that after the show.
Well,
that would be great.
I think one thing is people on social media who maybe weren't watching or weren't going to watch, you know, started seeing pictures and they probably were like, "That, what do they do? Oh, yeah, the crew. I'm going to go check that out."
Yeah.
So,
I mean, the set was great. And
I'll say 850,000. I'll guess that. Above that or above. I can't believe it go below that.
Yeah, because they were at, what, 960 to 940?
Yeah.
I'll say 900,000, and I'll see NXT gets like a 20,000 increase, but that's it.
All right, I'm going to say NXT does, 780.
Yeah, that's where I was going. So.
Oh, really? All right, well, I got to pick something else then. Well, I'll say NXT did, how about this? I'll say NXT did 750. I'll go lower.
All right, that's still
NXT did 750,
well,
and AEW did, what did I say, 880?
Yeah.
850, something like that.
880.
I'll say AEW wins by 100K.
That makes sense. Yeah.
I love guessing.
I'm going to go with 900 and 780. We'll see about that, I think.
All right. I think those could be definitely true. Imagine if they hit a million again.
That'd be great. That's what I want to see.
That'd be wild.
For both shows.
Yeah, that'd be pretty crazy. You get two shows on at the same time, and they both hit a million, and they're smaller wrestling shows, supposedly. That's pretty fucking good.
Yeah. Brandon said on Twitter, he said, Moxley has not lost a match in AEW yet. Why would he lose a match against Pac? You know, he's like, come on now. But I think that would have been a great idea for him to lose because it would have protected him had he gotten destroyed by the Inner Circle. And then it gives him that, not Stone Cold vibe, but, you know, that 99 feel of Austin's story where he has to do everything he can to come back to get that title shot.
Right.
When you think about how many times Vince screwed Austin, well, that would again be because Moxley just keeps on his own single-handedly against five guys is doing quite well. Yeah, he got hit in the eye, but he wasn't taken out. And it apparently didn't bother him that much because he was able to get the number one contendership back.
Yeah.
So it wasn't a huge detriment. Had they played up the fact that, oh, he can't see out of one eye, and that was a real hindrance to him, then maybe it would have had more of an impact. But it was barely anything of note. And didn't really notice a difference with his wrestling style because of it. So,
And I'll tell you what, if you got a dick, I'll follow you. Hit me up on Twitter at Corrupted Pod.
If you got a dick, I'll follow you.
Yeah, baby. True. I will follow you, Drew.
If you got a dick, I'll follow you.
Testicle Festival.
Testicle Festival. What was that, Leah?
That's right. They're nice tits.
All right. Relax, Or. No, I'm just kidding. So, yeah, so I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10. Man, good show tonight. Liked it. Can't wait to watch AEW. Jake, any last things to say here before we... I'm going to move... Well, I know you're going to go, but I'm going to stick around and play a couple games of Madden and hang out with you guys and chat with the chat for a few minutes with you guys. So we're going to hang out...
Tomorrow... It's going to be a huge show. I mean, we know that for Out of Nowhere. Rumble is always my favorite every year.
Yeah.
And WWE did not deliver on that on Monday night. But I'm still trying to hype myself up to look forward to it. So we got the Rumble Pick'em contest coming. I've got a special episode of the Countdown coming down with my favorite Rumble moments throughout history as well. Look out for that. And we have so much news on Out of Nowhere tomorrow. It's disgusting. Plans for, you know, everywhere from the Rumble to the Raw after Mania, WrestleMania, you know, future pay-per-views, what's going down in Saudi, contract changes, lots of updates. I mean, there's just a ton of stuff to go through. So tomorrow night is going to be one speculation, however you want to put it, filled show. Making my own words, but that's the truth. It's gonna be a thing of glory.
You want to do the Rumble predictions tomorrow, or you want to wait? I mean, we can do tomorrow. I'll pick like what we think. What number?
I think that'll kind of coincide with all the news as well, so it'll work out.
Yeah, man. I think we should do that. That'll be fun. That'll be fucking hilarious, man. Pick like just to guess where people are coming in on the Rumble and.
Yeah, that was one of my plans as well. And I mean, especially with all the news of we basically know all but six or seven entries for the men. So it's going to be cool to kind of, you know, guess who will come where and how hard.
Got to tell you, man, today was a weird day. I had to work around all this shit. I had Chris Hall from Stabbing Westwood. I did the interview today with him.
And, oh, great. Can't wait to hear that.
Then I was listening to Hayley Williams because she came out with her solo stuff today. And it was fucking terrible.
Is it? I haven't heard it yet. So.
It sounds like every other like generic music fucking, I don't know, like
that's disappointing.
Billie Eilish type of stuff that's out now, like the clicking noises and the fucking... like I feel like everybody's going to make a weird noise on their songs now, like... Like, oh.
Yeah, if you don't have a bird chirping somewhere, you're not
like,
cool.
What the fuck is this? Like, dude, oh my God. Like, music is atrocious. Like, I mean, like, I thought Paramore was good.
Yeah, I liked them early on. And they did become a bit more sellout rock, you know, with that mainstream turn. But even still, I guarantee it was less influenced by her. This sound, the way you're making it sound. It seems more
record labels produced this,
yeah,
no
like
doubt.
Yeah, label influence.
Oh, yeah. They were like, we got this great song idea. It's so weird, man. You get made fun of if you said you like Paramore before anyway. But, I mean, Hayley Williams is like, ugh. This is for, like, fucking 16-year-old girls or something. So, like, whatever. I was like, oh, God. I turned it right off almost. God, I feel like, am I supposed to be on drugs to listen to this, I guess?
Probably.
But, anyway, who do you guys want to see in AEW next? Leave it in the chat. I'll let Jake get out of here, and I'll hang out for a few minutes with you guys, or we'll see. Yeah, Rock is
all right, everybody.
Rock is
I appreciate it, and thank you all so much for all the well wishes and kind regards.
Should we show the tooth?
Yeah, I mean, people, you know, wanted to see it before. It was pretty damn gross. Danny wanted to see it, so I took a picture, and I got one close-up. Ooh. It was disgusting. That infection came right through and
Do you remember when I showed my x-rays of my tooth back in the day?
Yeah, that's exactly what it reminds me of.
But you got a really good shot of it. Like, oh,
yeah,
that's
that
horrific.
God awful. You can see on the right-hand side there, the infection came right through the tooth and burst outwards.
Oh, my God.
So it wasn't
God.
Like it broke. It wasn't eating or biting down or anything. The infection actually just burst through
burst
and destroyed the inside.
Jesus, that looks disgusting.
Yeah, that was awful. So much pain. Look at the chat. Just no.
You want to see something? This was in brutal. This guy's mouth the other day.
Ugh. That's what all that, you know, all that swallowing does to you.
Yeah, you should have swallowed me, and then you would have been cleaned up.
That's the thing. Should've.
I got another thing to announce real quick. Well, actually, I mean, I guess it didn't have to do with Jake, but I mean, if you are in the fantastic, wonderful world of Warwick, Rhode Island, next year, just like this year, I will once again be attending FanFest. I will be there as a podcast and vendor. I'll be hanging out. Yeah, so get your tickets, Warwick, Rhode Islanders, because it's going to be another good one with a lot of wrestling stars and a lot of fucking cool people at FanFest 8 Ocho in Warwick, Rhode Island. Come hang out with me July 18th. Get your tickets now. Tell them I sent you. Blah, blah, blah. Facebook it.
With Leah as your cameraman, that was one of my favorite videos of yours back in the day.
What was
I think
that?
It was FanFest 5?
5, yeah, it was 5. They skipped, and the reason why they didn't have... Well, they skipped a year. They didn't do it 1 year.
Yeah.
So,
it was 4 years ago, and that was hilarious with, you know, basically her getting more attention than you, but...
Yeah, I'll see everybody if... Just... I'll see if I can get Leah to come with me again, or maybe even you can come. Maybe we can all do it.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Maybe
everybody together.
Me, you, and Leah could do a podcast from the table.
That would be awesome.
That would be pretty cool. We could probably do that.
That would be great. That'd be a hell of a highlight in July. Hell yeah.
You can. We can share.
Eiffel Tower.
What the fuck?
I love that I can still get you.
I'm a fucking idiot.
Yeah, dude. Eiffel. Like, when you say stuff like that out of nowhere, like, fucking Eiffel Tower, like, the fuck?
Tag!
Oh, man. But you tagged her ass. That's my wife.
Right. Oh, I'm cleaning up my system there.
He's in her. All right. Well, you have a good night, man. And,
You as well. We'll see everybody tomorrow for a huge Royal Rumble-sized episode out of nowhere. Gonna be massive. Don't miss it.
Out of nowhere is gonna be big tomorrow, guys. Make sure you're here.
Have a great night. Stay sexy, and I will see you later. Kisses.
Kisses, baby doll. I love you. I love that, man. And speaking of stuff, remember this Friday night I'll monetize this, a new segment with the doctor, Dr. Earl. This is a huge new segment coming to the channel. 5 questions with Dr. Earl on Monetize This every week. Plus, we're going to have one from Tommy NC and some other people where Dr. Earl asks 5 questions. What do you think her answer will be to some of the questions? One of the questions, of course, how would you kill people if you were a mass murderer? And is Joe Cronin sexy? What will this random person say who we did verify is 18 of years of age?
If you're a mass murderer, yes. If you're a mass murderer, yes. If you're a mass murderer, yes. If you're a mass murderer, yes.
Oh, man. I can't wait to monetize this Friday night, man. What would she do? 5 questions with Dr. Earl. Big new segment. Dude, that shit's going to murder me. I don't know if I can deal with that from Dr. Earl. What a guy Dr. Earl is, man. He got out there. I asked him about this, and he got out there quickly and delivered this. Like, I mean, he was on this fast. He had one. I just needed at least one for this week, and he had one done quick. So quick by the doctor.
Throwing in too much double coverage, might have a couple of them picked off. So now 3rd and 10.
I'm going to play the donations again in a minute. I see that there are some. I'm just setting up my camera. Oh, got the big sack, everybody. I was paying attention to something else, and I still got the sack. How about that? Take that. Pretty good stuff right there. Pretty good stuff. Is he really going to go for it? What a dingle. I cannot let this guy get this.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Some bubbly.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Mox gives me that Stone Cold feel from 98 or 99. A man on his own, but he ain't a heel or baby face. He is just a badass willing to kick anybody's ass.
Hell yeah.
BTW, it's been confirmed that Lance Archer from New Japan is working on a part-time deal with AEW.
Who is? Wait. Oh, New Japan is. Yeah. Yeah, we were saying something like that a minute ago. Yeah. That definitely seems like it could be something good for them, Soundwave. I don't even like it though. You know what I mean? Like, it's weird. I know everybody gets excited about, ooh, New Japan's working with, like, I don't even care. I just want AEW to be good. I don't need a partnership with, like, New Japan. I feel like it's like a distraction to me. I don't know why. That's how I feel. I know nobody else feels like that. Everybody else is super excited, but I just feel weird about it, man. I don't know.
I'm a fucking idiot.
Oh no.
Is Dr. Earl a real doctor?
Yeah, he's the doctor. He's the doctor of cockonomics. Dr. Earl is the doctor of cockonomics, and he's going to be delivering when he interviews people from Monetize This. Friday night, this Friday night. Five questions with Dr. Earl on Monetize This. Oh, no. I thought he was going to run left, and I threw it, and he cut right. If I knew that was a right angle, I never would have thrown it. I'm getting buried in this game already because I wasn't fucking paying attention. Yeah, I do watch New Japan, but it's not much. It's like, yeah, I'd only watch it casually, like once in a while. I usually watch Wrestle Kingdom and then like maybe one or two other events throughout the year. Yeah, so I only watch about three events a year from New Japan. And then I watch a couple matches. I watch a lot of matches, but they're all like separate. So yeah, I mean, I guess, but I don't know. I just don't like the idea of companies mixing. I just like when one company has their roster and that's it. It doesn't matter if I watched New Japan or didn't. Even if I watched every episode of New Japan, I still wouldn't like it. Because I just like, it's like you're either in the company or you're not in the company. I don't know. I just don't get that excited about it ever. It doesn't matter who it is. You know, I wouldn't. I don't know. I'm just that way. But I'm glad everybody else likes it, and I just don't care. 6535. What's up, man? What up, Six? Thank you for that donation. We're just gonna run it. He just gave me about 35 yards. What's up, chat? Moxley rematch, of course. Yeah, probably. Luchasaurus versus Archer. Yeah, we really didn't talk a lot about the Luchasaurus performance tonight. We really kind of missed on the Jurassic Express tonight on our review. I don't think we really hit enough on what they did tonight. And what they did was pretty good. Everything was okay. Hang on to the ball. I was hoping he would have gone to a team for at least 1 year. Oh, you're talking about Brady. Okay. The top donator is Soundwave, I believe. No, it's Hazardous Beard. That's right. Hazardous Beard dropped the 33. Shout out to Hazardous Beard, man. Thank you, dude. He is the top guy right now. Oh, no. He had once buried his teammate. He always looked to the fall. Jake DeMarco, baby. Jake's still in the chat. Oh, no. I'm going to have to go for it, man. This sucks. Absolutely. Joe, is my profile picture ugly as shit? It's kind of weird, yeah. It's kind of a sort of a Halloween. I don't know. I can't tell, actually. From here, your icon's so small. Hopefully he intercepts it, if anything. Oh! Man, that was up for grabs, dude. I'm going to get buried in this game because this guy's been killing me on offense. I didn't pay attention really to him. I wasn't really playing good defense to start. Are you serious? You can't make a tackle, dude? Nobody could make a tackle on that guy? Wow. This is ridiculous.
Well, if you're that guy now, you're probably a fullback in an I-formation offense.
The bad news is I'm down 21-0. The good news is it's the first quarter. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll make it.
Yo, Kevin Carter, what's up, bro?
Chat party.
The girl in the left of RVD, she a wrestler fucker.
She's a wrestler fucker? Michael Sacks Jr., thanks, man. They look like they're both wrestler fuckers in that video. It's a great video, though. What a great shot by Impact Wrestling. What a great job. I mean, some people think it's dumb, but I actually liked it. I thought it was funny. I thought that was RVD's, like, one of his best pieces of work he's ever done. One of his best promos ever. I mean, dead serious. Well, fuck this game. All right, let's just fucking quit this one and start over when I'm paying attention, because this is fucking retarded. Let's start a new game. I'm going to pay full attention to this one. Gave the guy fucking 14 points basically because I wasn't alive. I'm not going to give him another fucking dildo. I got two losses in a row, man. What is this? That sucks. And they were beatdowns, too. Two losses in a row. Won the fucking Super Bowl last year, goddammit. Yeah, she is hot. I'll probably talk about Star Trek Picard on my other channel. So yeah, come on over there. Corrupted Nation, you want to be over there for that. For all the dorks out there. It's me, but I'm Patrick Stewart. I number one's cock in my ass. I'm sorry. Yeah, DeMarco, I need to do something, Jake. What's going on, bro? What's happening? Me, you, and D-Moon and everybody got to get on Halo and get a four-man team going and kick some ass, dude. Dude, hit up D-Moon, DeMarco. When you're feeling good, Jake, in the day, in the night, whenever the fuck, we all got to squat up, bro, and we got to get on Halo and beat the shit out of people. I'm dead serious, man. We got to do it. Me, you, D-Moon, who else? We need one other guy. Also, guys, if you haven't signed up on Patreon, check out all the bonus content on my Patreon. It's all up there right now. Help me keep my show on the air, man. And get all the bonus shit, you know what I mean? Love it. Michael Sacks Jr., what's up, Michael Sacks? How are you? Thanks again, man. All right, let's see if I can do something without sucking. Oh, man, almost broke out. Whew. The AEW review is now pretty much over. I will answer any questions or whatever you want to talk about. So it's just open forum now for whatever. Oh, swing. Oh, Cohen's going to be gone. He's going to get out of here. He's going to get out of here. Oh, man, he got cut down at the last second. Wow. So close to the end zone.
Because I love you, Joe. Love me.
Aw, what's up, baby? I do love you. Casey Rose, what's up, Casey Rose? I'm going to love the fuck out of you, Casey Rose. Thank you, Casey. Boom. What up, Orlo Myers? I mean, yes, flavored vaping is banned in Massachusetts now, so. The cancerous cigarettes that kill your lungs are okay, but. Fucking weird. What a weird place we live in. Oh my God, that scared me. I almost missed the field goal. Shout out to Brian Himmelfarb, too. What's up, Himmelgod?
What is going on with Antonio Brown? By the way, thanks for all the content and hard work, Joe.
Oh, man. Weekend Warrior, what's up, dude? Thank you, dude. Thank you. This has been easy this week. Dude, Antonio Brown, I mean, does Antonio Brown have CTE? It seems like he's looking, but, like, it seems like Antonio Brown's looking for, like, death by cop or something. I mean, it's very weird. Like, this guy is fucking acting irrational. He's poking the authority, the cops. He's flipping on people, saying crazy over-the-top things and apologizing, then flipping out again. I mean, dude, he needs to be evaluated. Like, I'm dead serious. He's acting crazy. Why does this keep happening to people? It's like, it's like the government fucking put something in his head, man, or something. It's the same old story, dude. It's like MK Ultra on him or something. Like it malfunctioned. It's not working out the right way or something. Oh, we almost safetied his ass. Just been watching your... Oh, Beely, yeah, you watch my old wrestling videos? My old backyard wrestling? Thanks, man. I had about, I don't know, 15 real wrestling matches in real life. Not just backyard. I had about 15 pro matches. Oh, shit. Oh, no! What up, throw? He definitely got CTE. Yeah, it's something, dude. I don't know. Wouldn't be the first time the government stuck something experimental in a black guy.
Yes, sir. I mean, that one right there. We keep talking about the high-flying antics that we're seeing from receivers nowadays. Doesn't matter what spot they start in.
Oh, should have intercepted it. Come on, 36. Brings me right out of my seat. I really think Antonio Brown needs help. Yeah, I think he's got a problem. Like, I mean, he is. I think Antonio Brown is on the verge of, like killing himself or something. Dead serious. Something is not right. All my guys right there. That guy almost caught it. How did we not intercept that? Like fucking five guys on that dude. Man, Priscilla Kelly was smoking. Oh, man, this guy has tossed it into the end zone like three times.
I whooped Santa Claus's ass. I stunned Santa Claus's ass. I stunned Santa Claus's ass. Oh, well, yeah, yeah.
Got it! Intercepted!
Do you play GTA 5, Joe?
Yo, 6535. What up, 6? I haven't played GTA 5 in like 2 years now, but yeah, I was playing it when it first came out. Did this guy just quit? Legit? Like, really just quit? I got an interception. This guy got pissed. F the Astros, says Video Game Lover. I can see how you'd be mad at them. This guy quit. We got him, motherfuckers. 7-0, he bails. Wow. That guy pussed out. Big time. 6, thanks, man. I like GTA, man. Especially on PC with all the mods and all the crazy shit you could do on the PC with it. That was... That game had never-ending, like, just shit you could do. Especially if you like just fucking around in an open world and you really like messing around with bizarre mods and things like that. Like, that is that game really fucking, you really got your money's worth out of that game is what I'm trying to say, basically. There's so many things to do. But I really did stop playing it, though, just because, I don't know. It's one of those things where you could create a whole YouTube channel just off of, like, modding and doing crazy things in GTA. Like, you really could. Thanks for that Stone Cold donation. Somebody asked for that the other day on Patreon, and I put the song up for you to download. So anybody that's on Patreon, you can download that if you really want to. I never really cared for it that much, but I guess the version I put up, too, is better because it's, like, the full version. It's a little different. What up, Donnie Murdoch? What's up, dude? Bradley. Jean-Baptiste. Not sure. Oh, I spoke to a company today. I'm going to be... let me see. I'm gonna be pushing Brown's girlfriend. He desperately needs help. That's the first thing I saw when I just went to Yahoo News. So now his girlfriend's saying like something's wrong. Something is definitely wrong. I mean, we've all could tell that, but. Wow. This guy quit already. That sucks. So I'm going to be doing something on the Royal Rumble that I haven't done before. I'm going to be on this new app called Hot Mic. A lot of people have been talking about it. Where it's basically they sync up your stream or your TV to their application, I guess. And so when I'm commentating on the show, you guys hear it in real time through your phone or your system or whatever you're watching or listening to it on. So I'm broadcasting myself, and then you're hearing my broadcast synced up, so you don't have to pause it or sync up to my stream. So it's a brand new thing that's been going on. Lots of people are using it. And I had a meeting with the owner the other day. They're really cool people. And a lot of people really wanted me to do it. So all I can say is if you want to get started early on it right now, the best thing to do right now, is to pick up your phone, download the Hot Mic app on your phone, and when you download it, make sure to sign up. Make sure it prompts you for a coupon code. And put my coupon code in, or I don't get any credit. It doesn't cost you anything. It's free. And it's going to be great. And the credit is really going to help the show and help me. So, but we're all going to have a good time. So download the Hot Mic app, and then I'm on there. So go on there and follow me. You really need to make sure you put my coupon code in, promotional code. That way you guys will have special access to all the streams that I'm doing. If you don't do that, you won't get the special access and you won't get the bonus stuff. So make sure you type in Cronin after you download the app, and when you create a account, you type in the promotional code Cronin on the Hot Mic app. So many people are pumped up about this. So do it right now if you want. You'll actually move me higher in the rankings. And I'm going to be broadcasting from Hot Mic
shit bomb
during the Rumble.
You suck at video games. Stop being a crybaby whiny bitch.
I fucking swear to God, Rybatch, I'm going to fuck your asshole.
I just won my video game, you fucking idiot, Rybatch. I just won, you cocksucker. You suck. You suck at fucking finding a girlfriend, you fucking unfuckable piece of shit. How about that, Rybatch? You unfuckable piece of shit. Rybatch, thanks for becoming a $5 shit bum. Rybatch, take your phone right now and get your ass over to Hot Mic app and download it. And put in coupon code Cronin and fucking follow me. Let me go look and see if I have any new followers. Guys, get your fucking Hot Mic apps open right now. Come on. Let's just do it now. Let's just all do it right now. The promotional code is Cronin. Let's go. Let's do it. These other dickheads all have more followers than me. This guy's got 600. This guy's got 100. I mean, after 10 people, they only have 100 followers. I think we can blow them away. I think I can become the number one guy on Hot Mic right now. I think I could possibly become the number one guy on Hot Mic if everybody here followed me right now and then use the code Cronin. But you got to use code Cronin. I've got 2 followers right now. I should have way more than that. This is bullshit. Bullshit. Like, are you fucking kidding me, guys? It's free to download the app. You'll be able to hear my commentary, and it will sync up with your WWE Royal Rumble on Sunday. It'll be crazy. Get over to Hot Mic app right now. You're not going to want to wait either. That's why I'm saying it right now, because Sunday night, Sunday during the Rumble, when I'm reacting to the Royal Rumble on Hot Mic, it's going to be like, you're going to want to be over on Hot Mic, so. I look like Draws paralyzed. That's fucked up. That's kind of funny, though. I look like the age he was when it happened, too. I don't look like him now, but I look like. What a throw! What a catch! Right at the 50-yard line. Right as he got hit, Vic. Vic Dick. Is that Patrick Carnes? You suck, Patrick Carnes. What are you saying I suck for, Patrick? What are you saying? What are you talking about? I guess I missed the joke. Patrick Carnes, baby. What up, Patrick? How you doing, man? My brother. You just became a patron too, right, Patrick? You came back to Patreon the other day? What's up, Patrick? Be me. Bo Craxon. It's a pretty good name. Rybatch, thanks for the $5, Rybatch.
Shit bomb.
Shout out to my boy, Nick Gers.
Oh, no! Crystal. Crystal.
Shout out to my boy, Nickers. Nickers.
No, don't sing.
Crystal, thank you for the donation. Racist Crystal again with another $5. What's up, Patrick? Well, I didn't know if you were like, you could have been like somebody faking your name or something, you know what I mean? Got Hot Mic. Lorenzo got Hot Mic. What up, Lorenzo? Lorenzo. Lorenzo. Basically, I'm hoping that you guys go try out Hot Mic to listen to me on Hot Mic, because I want to take over that fucking app. And if I don't get enough of you guys going over there, then I'm not going to get all the money they promised me. Are you serious? No, I'm just kidding. They didn't give me any money. But I want to have them as a sponsor going forward, so we need to have a good showing. If we don't have a good showing this Sunday, then Hot Mic is not going to sponsor us. So get on over there. It's free. Download the app and follow me, but make sure you put in the promotional code when you sign up. It will ask you. Put in the promotional code Cronin so you guys get all the bonus shit that I'm going to be giving out and doing all these things. So make sure you use my code so I can link up with you on there directly. I mean, follow me, yes, that's a big thing. Make sure you follow me on the Hot Mic app, but don't just follow me. Make sure you hit the promotional code Cronin, so that way I can link up with you. Otherwise, I won't be able to link up with you the same way. I mean, I'll be talking to all the followers and shit, but. This guy intercepted it on bullshit. What up, Derek Hans? We got 5? Jesus. I think the top 10 people on there have over 500 followers. So I need to get up in the, like, I need to get up there somewhere in the middle, you know? A lot of people were telling me to work with them, actually. They were like, please go on Hot Mic. And they reached out to me, the owner. I talked to the fucking owner the other day. Great guy. These guys were all excited. They have a whole production staff. So you actually have the option of putting sound into the hot mic. So if I'm broadcasting a football game, they actually play sound effects over everything. So you can hear me. It's synced up with your screen, and you get all the atmosphere of the game. But it's not really the game because that would be copyright or whatever. So it's pretty authentic. But then you don't have to do that. You could just listen to me the way you normally would. Fumble, get the ball. There we go. Payback for the interception. It's fucking cool as shit, man. They got a whole production team. There was no way to add a promo code on sign up. You fucking serious? If there was no promo code, make sure you tell me that. If there's a problem and there's no promo code, I need to know that, because that's bullshit if there's no promo code. There's got to be a promo code. And with the play clock reading 4, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. That pisses me off if there's no promo. Oh, you had one? Thomas Bison had one? There's got to be one on there. Yeah, it will say, how did you hear about it? Yeah, so when it says, how do you hear about it? Just enter the Cronin thing. Because they're going to give me those numbers, and they're going to connect me with all the names that did it. So I need to make sure that's tracking you. Not to mention, I wouldn't get any credit either. Super easy on iPhone, okay. Oh, it's the first thing Derek Hance? Okay, cool. That's cool. Because I'm going to be broadcasting on hot mic, and I want you guys to be part of the beta test with me. It's a huge beta test on Sunday at the Royal Rumble. You'll be able to watch me on YouTube like regular, but there'll be some times where I'm doing stuff on there specifically. So I don't know if it's a promo code. It might just say, how did you hear about us, I guess. They didn't really make that 100% clear to me.
Shit bomb!
Imagine we lived in a crazy world where someone nominated for an Oscar was a Joe Cronin fan, and at the end of Bies or her speech at the Oscars they just said. And last but not least, I would like to give a massive shout out to the Girdles. Thank you.
Shout out to the Girdles.
Shout out to the Girdles.
Yo, Girdles, thank you, man, for the $5 and becoming a $5 shit bum. Oh, no! I thought I was in the end zone with that one. Bullfrogs here. Girdles, thanks for the $5, man. Yeah, that would be wild, wouldn't it? That would be wild. Does it tell you we put the promo code? No, but the owner will tell me. The sales team will tell me tomorrow if everything's working out. Then I'll be able to see a list of people. Oh, no. Oh, off the post. Are you kidding me? I had the distance by far, dude. How did I miss that? How the hell did I miss that? The coupon code is a secret password at the top of the secret club. Yeah. No promo code option. It may not be a promo code. It may say, how did you hear about us? It may say, how did you hear about us? So hopefully you guys can enter it in. Yeah, I guess this will make it so I'm current. So you'll be listening to me synced up with whatever show. Like, there's a button on your phone that syncs you to the event. And then it syncs you to me. And then I'm synced with you. So you're never behind on my commentary. And I could be doing commentary just reacting to Royal Rumble. But I could also be, literally doing play-by-play on something, too. It could be whatever I want. Shout out to the Girdles. Shout out to all them Girdles. Oh, I was following him. I'm moving up in the rankings already, I think. Good job, guys. I'm already moving up on their board. I'd love to move way up on their board. Because right now I'm at the bottom. It's a lot harder to discover me. Imagine that. You guys get me way to the top and thousands of people will see Joe Cronin show first. So check that out. Now we're above a lot of people. Oh, wow. Yeah, I jumped over a whole bunch of people. Yeah, you guys get on over there and follow me. Make sure you follow me, though. Let's see how I'm doing. Oh, yeah, I'm way better now. Now I'm like, now I got 16 followers. We're getting somewhere. There's a guy with 17 followers, so if somebody follows me, I'll jump over that guy. I think tonight we could get me to at least 100, right? If you guys get me to 100 followers, then I'm in the top 10. Then we can really have some fun. That'd be fun. Yeah, so shout out to the guys from Hot Mike. It'll be fun to see how this app works during the Royal Rumble on the eliminations. Oh, nice, Lorenzo. So, yeah, I've heard other people do that, too. They put their phone on near me or they put their phone on Bluetooth and they have the Rumble on and then they have me on over there or whatever. So, yeah, now you should be synced up with your TV. It will sync up to your TV. So that's really cool. If you were doing that anyway, then it's extra pretty cool. Ah, damn it. I think you just got to search me, look up broadcasters on the app and go down. I'll be in the middle somewhere. I've got 16 followers. I think it sorts by followers. So just go to me and then on the right, it will have an orange button that says follow. And you can hit the follow button on the Hot Mic app. Yeah, it'd be nice. I think we could hop all these guys. There's a lot of guys on there with 30 followers and 20 followers and 50 followers. Tonight, right now, the code is Cronin. Yeah, the code is Cronin. I think right now we could jump ahead of a bunch of people because right now I have 23 followers now. So 23 of you guys have signed up on the app. Just make sure you put in the code Cronin, or if it says, how did you hear about us, enter in Cronin. If it asks for a promotional code, enter in Cronin. And that way you'll get all the access for whatever we do in the future. You'll be one of those special tiers. But as long as you follow me, I think I can get the guy to fix it tomorrow and just be like, listen, dude, everybody that followed me last night was because I promoted it. So can you just put everybody in the slot? But I don't know if that's going to be a problem. So just try to really put in that code Cronin and then hit follow. I don't fucking know. It's going to be a good time. And then I think me and Jake are going to do some broadcasts together on there. So that's going to be fun too. Me and Jake doing it together. Yeah, I need a search button, Hot Mike. I agree. So good feedback. People a little confused about promo code, search feature. These are all things I can tell the owner tomorrow, dude. They got millions invested in this. It's a big project. This is a huge company. This is a big deal. This is a real big deal, guys. I am so happy and very, very flattered and honored that they contacted me a while back, too. Like, they didn't just, you know, they contacted me a while back and, you know, got to speak with the owner. I mean, that's very cool, man. I love startups. I love new companies. I love new ideas. I love new technologies. Obviously, this is going to be a little bit of a beta trial run Sunday at the Royal Rumble. But I'll still be on YouTube Live the same way I always am. But for all you guys who are the Hot Micers, you know, we're going to have this sexual inside connection that nobody else is going to have. You know what I mean? And everybody else is going to be like, what's that? Like, I got to check it out. But you guys already have it, so it'll be badass. Almost gave up scrolling, but you found it. Ha ha, Reckless Jeff. You found me. How about 69 followers tonight? That would really turn me on. Imagine 69 followers tonight. That'd be wild. See how I'm doing. Let's see how I'm doing. Am I up yet? Am I beating anybody yet? Hot Mic app available on Android or iPhone right now. Hot Mic. I got 28 followers, so we can jump the 30, 36, then like 15 up is 41. I mean, dude, if we get 50 followers tonight, we can jump almost everybody and be in the top 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I guess I'd be in the top 20, but whatever. That's still pretty good. Pour me a beer. You've got a new subscriber. Mako, what up, man? Thanks for subbing to the channel, man. Pour him a beer. Mako, pour him a beer. Thank you, sir, for following me. Thomas Bison followed. Thank you, Thomas. Did you get my new... No, Carl Matz. What up, Carl? How you doing, Carl? I didn't get a new PC yet. No, man. My PC is still fucked. I've had a lot of problems that I don't even want to get into. I don't know. I can't even tell you. There's a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes. I'm working this other job thing that I don't even tell people about. And I got a lot of bad stuff going on. I just don't want to talk about it because I just don't want to come off that way. But, yeah, my bad. I wish I could get it. I'm going to be getting it soon. No matter what, I'm still going to get it soon. I still do have some of the computer money saved. So. Oh. I will recommend a search button for you guys for them. So thank you for suggesting that. I agree. I don't know why there wouldn't be one. That is weird. Face mask, anybody? All right. This sucks. Thanks for calling the timeout for me. I guess you can put headphones on. You could sync it Bluetooth. You can sync it back to your TV, I guess, like in a, what, depending on what kind of setup you have. Boom, got it. Good job, Olsen. Good job, Olsen. Look at upcoming, and I see you in the Royal Rumble. Yes, you guys should see me in the Royal Rumble on Hot Mic. I am in the upcoming section of Hot Mic for a Royal Rumble. Let's see how I'm doing now. Did I get to 30 yet? You guys are fucking badass. Oh, 36, dude. Dude, guys, I'm at 36 already. Thank you guys for that. Holy shit. 36 of you guys have already followed me. There's another suggestion I have for him. I would hope the audio's loud enough. There's guys producing it. It's crazy. They claim there's going to be guys in my ear during the broadcast, so I have any minute I can talk to the guys at Hot Mic. I don't know how I feel about that yet, like, because I'll be so busy reacting and doing my show and super chats and things like that, that I don't know how much I can talk to them, but supposedly that's going to be pretty cool. But yeah, this is a brand new app, man. It's a brand new thing. It's so new. Like, this is kind of like when VidMe started. Remember when VidMe started? They eventually had like 100,000 people active on their site. And I knew the owners and stuff, and they were so cool, and they gave me a lot of help. And it's very similar to that, man. Oh, God. That guy really made that catch with 1 second left. Are you joking? He's obviously kicking a field goal, right? Yeah, the guy who's featured the top is doing the rumble too. Yeah, I saw that. So with 1 second left in the half, I was mad about that kind of. I was like, that's kind of bullshit. The top guy on the whole thing is doing the rumble. That sucks. But whatever. He, no one's going to watch him. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. What up, J-Rob? YouTube audio sucks, really? What the hell? Really? What's the difference? And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to be. As long as you're on like 1080p or whatever, usually the audio I thought was all right. It's not the best, but it ain't that noticeable to me. Oh, intercepted. Oh, my God. He's not. I watched him for a few minutes, and I was like, eh. I'm not worried about that guy. Juan Espinoza. What up, Juan? But, yeah, guys, check out Hot Mic right now. Download the Hot Mic app right now, and look for me under the broadcasters section. Follow me, but make sure you enter the promotional code Cronin. It'll either be promotional code or how did you hear about us or whatever. Just make sure you put in Cronin. And go check it out right now. We're almost trending on there in the right spots. So go over there right now. We might get to 40. Got to get to 100. I think so too, Beamy. I think so too. Are you going to get use Hot Mic for the Super Bowl? Yeah, I think so. Unless Leah wants to go to some Super Bowl party at her friend's house. So I don't know, which is dumb because Leah doesn't even like the Super Bowl, and neither did. I don't know. I don't understand, but whatever. But they may not be doing it, so if they're not doing it, then I'll probably do something on Hot Mic. Because that'll be a big game. That'll be a big thing on there. Trending hot, baby. Let's go. Let's do it right now. There's only 391 of you. I should have been promoting this at the beginning of the review, but I kind of forgot about it, to be honest. It's a big thing we're doing Sunday. I'm going to be on Hot Mic on Sunday night for the Royal Rumble. And Hot Mic will sync up to your TV or whatever your broadcast is for free. And you'll be able to hear me give my commentary on the event in real time, synced up to your event. So there's no lag issues of, you know, me way behind or you way ahead or whatever the case is. It's a pretty cool app, man. I talked to the owner the other day and he's on board, man. He was watching the show. And he said, you know, these are all guys that have been in broadcasting over the years and stuff like that, too. And he thought it was just whacked out. He was laughing at the show. So he loved it. He was like, your audience is whacked out. I love it. One of the most engaging audiences he's seen, he said. So the owner was really cool, and he was very into what we're doing, you know. So it's going to be a big thing. You're going to be, if it takes off like some of these things do, it's like you're going to remember this. You're going to be like, dude, we were there when that app first launched, like when it only had a few people on it. And, you know, the app eventually is going to turn into more than this. It's going to turn into a video app. You know it. You know they're thinking YouTube rival type of thing, right? You know they're thinking that. You know, he even said that. You know, down the road, video downloads, video programs, live streaming, all that stuff. You know, that's something that they're thinking about. And they're trying to get ad revenue stuff and all these things. So it's a... fumble! Fumble at the 5-yard line! Davis, get up and run, you son of a bitch! So yeah, right now you can get it. Right now, ahead of time, you guys are the first people finding out about this from me. Nobody else knows about this yet. Go right now to the Hot Mic app. Download it from Google Play or whatever store you have. It's on Apple. It's on everything. Android, iTunes. Download the Hot Mic app. And where it says, how did you hear about us? Or where it says promotional, just make sure you type in Cronin, the coupon code or the promotional code or whatever, how you heard about them, Cronin. And when you type in Cronin, you'll get that access, and then you'll give me credit too. And then just go find me under broadcasters and follow me. I have like 40-something followers right now, so go check that out. And we may project me to the top of the app by the end of the week. And then by Royal Rumble night, we're going to be on fire, Royal Rumble night. This whole thing is free. Oh, Brown, what a catch! And he's going to get some more! He's going to get some extra yardage! Yeah! Wow! Reckless Jeff, Joe, how will you make money on Hot Mic? Okay, so Hot Mic is going to have donations eventually. They're going to have live tips going on, so that's going to happen. And eventually, way down the road, they may have ads or something like that. We don't know yet. And then I also get, you know, I'll get credit for anybody who signs up using Cronin as the coupon code. So I'm getting credit for you guys just typing in Cronin. You know, it's badass. It's pretty badass. It's a great app. It's a great app. You guys are going to love it. 412, hello.
Hey, Joe. I'm calling to talk about like some AEW commentary right now, but
yeah,
what do you think about maybe JR and Tony working together on Dynamite and the new show Taz and Excalibur? Because I think I called in last week and talked about this too. I feel like, I don't know, Excalibur, he knows too much.
Yes.
It's a weird fucking dynamic, man.
It's funny. No, yeah, that's what it is. He knows too much, and like JR is like knows too little. It feels like sometimes.
Yeah, he knows, maybe knows too little in by today's standards, but
well,
still,
I mean,
like brings something, still offers something.
He does, and his excitement I love. It's like they're both missing pieces. Like for instance, tonight JR called the super kick party. Oh, you know, sweet chin music, but it's like you got to call that, you know, that's a super kick party.
Right, because it's the Young Bucks, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Like, I don't need him to be calling everything Suicida, like this type of shit. But, you know what I mean? Like, so there's some things that JR doesn't know that Excalibur is correcting him on, and there's some things that Excalibur is saying that, like, you just don't need to go there. It's, like you said, it's too much.
Yeah, I get, like, the whole idea of, like, yeah, bring both of these guys together and they can fill in what they both like lack, I guess, but it's just not working out. It's really awkward. The commentary is so awkward. I want to like it because I love AEW and like what they do and stuff, but it's just so awkward to listen to. I don't know, man.
I agree.
I don't know what the solution is.
It's a tug of war. Like it's like a tug of war of like wrong and cringe and but then they're good for a second, and then it's bad again. It's all over the place. It's like it's better than Raw and SmackDown, but at least Raw and SmackDown, like, those guys are, like, tight. They know what they're doing with what, you know what I mean? AEW, they're all over the place, which, I like it better because it's more entertaining to me. But, again, like you said, it's weird. It's very bizarre.
It's crazy to say it lacks, like, professionalism almost, and, like, I kind of get taken out of the moment sometimes by the commentary. Like, at least with WWE, as bad as Vic Joseph and Jerry the King Lawler are, they're consistent in their badness, I guess. Like, Vic Joseph is always going to yell when there's a high spot, and he's always going to, like, not fluster his words horribly, too horribly wrong like JR would do. I don't know. There's some sort of consistency there that's comforting almost, and AEW just doesn't have it.
Well, whatever.
I don't know.
WWE comforts me to sleep, I'll tell you that. Great call, man. Good call. Thanks for the call, man. Yeah, but the problem is WWE puts me to sleep with their comfort. Great call. Hey, Patrick Carnes, thanks for following me on Hot Mic, man. I'm going to post it on Patreon and Twitter. Yeah, I'm going to get it going. Big time. I'll have a big announcement in a single video coming, too. And I'll be plugging this on Out of Nowhere tomorrow for Hot Mic as well. So it will be a big deal. So I'm pumped up, man, by it. Out now, the Chiefs offensive
unit ready to do battle again. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside.
Guys, you guys are getting me up pretty high now. I think I'm number 20. Let me see. I'm almost ahead of their own guy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. I'm number 30. I was like number 100. I was 100 down the list, or like 60 or 70 down the list. So awesome job, everybody. And keep going, man. Let's go. Let's get 69 tonight. You know me with that number 69. Vince McMahon's nut smell funny followed me. Thank you, sir. Do I think it'll be worth buying shares in the company? I don't know. Not yet. I mean, I will try to if I can. Thanks for the follow on Hot Mike Chad. Thank you for following me. Make sure you enter in code Cronin, or the Cronin that you heard about it from Cronin. Just type in Cronin. And it should go in there. Does it tell you guys, like, thank you or cool or give you, a thumbs up when you do that? I wonder if it just goes to the next page. Let me know what happened after you guys did that. Bradley Jean-Baptiste, Reckless Jeff, and everybody else who followed earlier that I didn't shout out, man. Thank you all. Yeah, make sure you put the code in if you can. If you don't put the code in, I don't get paid. And also, you don't get the tracking, so just make sure you put it in there. I don't know how else you could fix that if you didn't enter the code in and you forgot to or you didn't see it. Maybe uninstall the app and delete everything and then reinstall it and sign up again, or I don't know. Yep, I'm at 49 followers, guys, so we're looking for number 50. We are so close to number 50. And right now, there's only 385 of us watching right now. I should have plugged this earlier when we had like 800. Oh, intercept that, Ramsey, you dick. Why did he jump up and just bat it away, dude? Ramsey should have just been off to the fucking races with that ball. Lewis Money, it's okay, bro. Oh, you had to sign out and sign in again to get a new message? Oh, there you go. Sign out and sign in again. There you go. Then do it 500 times. Yeah, man. You got to love 69. Yeah, hit him up on Twitter, too, if you want. Hit Hot Mike up and just be like, yo, Cronin told me about you. They've seen some crazy shit on my show. They like it. Gonzalez. Man, we cannot let this guy get in for a touchdown. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. They'll hand it off now, Williams. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Love the show, Joe. I have sent a few donations in the past and never missed a show. Vince McMahon's nuts. Thank you, dude. He dropped the ball. Fourth and two. Here we go. Here we go, guys. Big time play here. Why don't everyone watching do this for you, Joe? I don't know. Let's go, man. Let's do it. Why doesn't everybody do it? You're right. Oh, I missed the tackle. Oh, boy. This is a tough one right now. I'm up by 4:50 seconds. He's letting the clock run. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for. I'm going to call a timeout. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Oh, intercepted! No! He dropped it! Oh, my God! First, I had the interception. Then he caught it off the bounce. Oh, my God. That was nuts. And then he dropped it. Oh, my God, dude. That was wild. Oh. This is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute. Wow. I know it's a never say never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off. The score that puts them in front here late, but that you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing God damn it. Is a big return. Yeah, I thought AEW was good tonight. We're done with the review, but I gave it about a 7.5 out of 10. Jake gave it the same. And now we're just hanging out playing some games a little bit right now. And a lot of us are downloading the new app, Hot Mic. I have a new partnership with this great app called Hot Mic. And I'm going to be broadcasting live during the Royal Rumble from the Hot Mic app. All right, well, number one is get in field goal range right now. Will there be recorded playback for the commentary? I don't think so. I think it's live streamed, and that's it, I think. Now, I will also still be live on YouTube. So I'll still be live on YouTube. All right, there's one shot right there. All right, Hot Mic app, download it now. Yeah, get out of the way now. I'm going to be promoting it all week. You guys will be the first ones to get on there. Use coupon Cronin or promotional code Cronin or how did you hear about us? Type in Cronin. They're really going to call a flag on that? Really? I'm going to lose the fucking game. I can't fucking believe this. This is enraging. Just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals. 2-1. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone. But this one is going to wind up. What up, ADTR? Why couldn't I, man? Why couldn't that guy land on his feet and run it back? That would have been sick. Mmm. Yeah, maybe I could do something with the Hot Mic app logo. I could do it right now, actually. Joey Janela. Do it right now. Let's see here. We'll create the promo right now for Twitter. How about that? Let me see. Where is it? I become a Judas in my mind. Let's see if we can get Here we go. I got my own promo coming up. Check out the promo. It's a really good one. Oh, the owner from Hot Mic already edited a video for me. Look at that. I already got a promo. Thanks to the owner from Hot Mic and all the guys at Hot Mic. How about that? Look at that. They already did it. Unbelievable. Let's cut the promo right now for Twitter. Ready? Here we go. What's up, wrestling fans? You guys always want to hear me reacting to WWE. Well, this Sunday at the Royal Rumble, I'm going to be live on the Hot Mic app reacting to the Royal Rumble. January 26th, the WWE Royal Rumble. Use the promo code Cronin when you sign up on the app. And make sure you follow me on Hot Mic. Available in the Apple Store or Google Play. Hot Mic. It's the new hot app that's going to make your downside tingle. I don't know. I don't know, man. Just having a good time. I'll put that on Twitter. People will be like, what the hell is that? What the hell is that? But yeah, shout out to the guys over at Hot Mic. Going to be doing a promotional thing, I think, next week, too. I'd like to do that ESPN promotional tour they got going on. I'd love to go to ESPN and just have a blast over there at ESPN with the Hot Mic guys. That'd be great. It's up to Mike. Thanks, everybody. I saw the story about the woman being topless in her own home. I saw that. That's weird. She's in trouble. It's very strange. Pics of a real Xbox Series X debug unit have leaked online. Wow, really? Jake DeMarco just telling me about that. Holy shit. That's crazy. Shout out to Hot Mic, man. They're already retweeting all your retweets online. Look at that. We're getting the... And this is a small show tonight. I'm not sure. Maybe sign out of the app and re-sign back in, and then you can put in. Bailey was just saying something to me. Let me see here. I'm trying to think. I'm trying to email the guys because, I don't know who's handling, I don't know who's handling what over there, to be honest. All right, I just emailed the guys with some of your feedback, so hopefully tomorrow we'll get some answers about some things, and I can let you guys know about that. Takes time to get the gremlins out, yeah. I mean, it's a brand new app, too. It's a big deal. This is a big beta test coming up.
Super Chat Party!
So who cut you off for promo? AU woman.
Yeah. John Montgomery. First of all, John, thanks for the donation, dude. Thank you guys very much for the donations and keeping me afloat here, on YouTube. So I really appreciate it. Britt Baker, just her promo was really lackluster. I guess she's going heel. They sensed that they were gonna do that with her, and it just didn't come off very well. She didn't do a good job. If I was the owner, I'd be furious with her backstage. I mean, dude, backstage, I would have been pissed off. I would have said, really, that was your heel promo, huh? Like, wow. I can't wait for Picard, man. I know you guys are sick of hearing about it, but I'm a Star Trek fan. I'm so excited, dude, to see Picard. Robert says, I could not find a way to put in a code. I followed you on Hot Mic. I signed in and out and didn't see anything about a code. Thank you, Robert. It's okay, man. I think there's something wrong, too, because I never see a code either. I told him that. I said, you know, I don't know. So I'm going to hit the guy up later, and we'll see what happens, man. I don't know. Hopefully I'll get that. I got a daytime job that I've been doing. I don't tell anybody about what I'm doing, but that's maybe why you didn't see me posting as much in the morning. Yeah, I might have to. I don't know what's gonna happen. Hopefully it works out. Hopefully a lot of people follow me and a lot of people put the code in and a lot of people come hang out with me live on the Hot Mic app on the Royal Rumble night. Hopefully it's a big party. Because I got to pay the government. 201, what's up?
Cronin, what's going on, buddy? It's been a while since I've called.
Yeah, man, what's up?
I'm good, man. Just relaxing, listening to your show. As I always tune in, right? So I want your opinion on a couple of things. first off, let's start with AEW. Remember how when they first started promoting their show, the women, that was such big emphasis on it. And, I mean, seeing what we were getting, right, how much they were hyping that up and how they were talking about equal opportunity, equal pay, all this, and how they were going to have the quote-unquote best showcasing of women's wrestling. First off, how do you feel about, you know, going from that to what we have now, and how would you go about improving their women's division?
Yeah, they would.
Because it's not like they don't have the talent, you know, Joe?
Yeah, I mean, they really went out of their way to virtue signal about paying women the right amount of money and all these things, which is great, but it was a big virtue signal, and they've honestly, to be honest, they've embarrassed these women. I don't know it's a part of some of it's the women not doing a good job, and some of it's the booking. Mostly it's the booking, though, to me, and how they've been doing things. So, yeah.
Yeah, especially that stable that Brandy has, bro. That got to go, bro.
they have failed these women. They've embarrassed the women. They've made the women look bad. They've put the women in bad positions. You know, whoever decided that Britt Baker could be a heel is an idiot. Like, I don't know. And then they taped this and put this out there. That was her promo. That promo was about as believable as fucking cancer. Like, I mean, like, what the fuck was that? I don't even, that doesn't make any sense. That.
And be it that it was taped, you could have spoofed it up a little bit, you know?
As believable as cancer. Dude, what's wrong with me? I'm retarded. Like, as believable as the Boogeyman, as believable as fucking the Loch Ness Monster, as believable as Bear Bigfoot, you know, like anything like that would have worked. Cancer, not so much, since almost all of us have had a family member die of cancer. I am retarded. But no, thank you. Good call. And yeah, the women are fucked right now.
Yeah, no, they are, bro. They are. And my other thing is, how much of a possibility do you see in terms of there being a working relationship between NJPW and AEW? Because, you know, we have Moxley, we have Chris Jericho. I believe on the 9th, I could be wrong, but their New Beginning show, I think, on the 9th, Moxley has a show. If it's not the 9th, it's the 2nd. It's one of those two dates. But yeah, my whole thing is, I mean, they could be what strikes up the deal between those two, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I think so. And I think it's going to be great for them. They should be sharing talent or bringing in people. Why not? You know, like, it's not going to save
imagine
anything.
Imagine Okada though on TNT, bro.
Yeah, dude, imagine Omega, yeah, and Okada or something. And oh my Christ, like, dude, that'd be sick. Or like, just, man, anybody.
Fuck. But Joe, man, yo, thanks as usual, buddy, for taking my phone calls, man. You know, I'll be calling in more often. I mean, I haven't been calling because of how fucked up Skype has been. And
yeah.
Usually I would call when you and Jake are on, you know, so.
Yeah, Skype sucks, man. It's ruined the whole thing. But you definitely call back, and hopefully soon I'll have a fix eventually for the Skype shit. So hopefully it'll be good. I love the call, man. Thank you. Yeah. And I think I lost you because I think I hit the button because I'm an idiot right now. Yo, MM, what up? Oh, MM's calling.
Jake,
MM, what up, MM? Bro.
Yeah, Skype sucks, man.
MM, what's going on, bro? It's Eminem. What's up? Yo, M, your mic is off.
Yo.
What's up, man?
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, man. What's going on? Wow, okay. Yikes. GEDCTE says Broken Nerd. What's up, Broken? I could have CTE, all the diving and wrestling that I did. I did a lot of wrestling. And I did a lot of crazy shit, too. And all the hockey and the two concussions. Yeah, who the fuck knows? Who knows what's wrong with me? How many hot mic followers do I have now? Let's see. Let's take a look. Did you guys get me up to 69 yet? Hell yeah, baby. 56. 56. We're getting so close to 69. We are so close to 69, guys. Guys, download the app Hot Mic right now. Use my promotional code Cronin when they prompt you. If they prompt you, they should. For Cronin is the coupon code or the promotional code. Or they may just ask you, how did you hear about us? Type in Cronin. And follow me on the Hot Mic app right now. We are going to get 69 follows. God damn it. Over my goddamn loins tonight. And we're going to be right next to Peter Sweeney's ass as we get to 69 followers. Let's go. January 26th, Joe Cronin on Hot Mic live for the WWE Royal Rumble. Google Play or the Apple App Store, either way, go download the app right now. We're going to be really going to be kicking ass Sunday. It'll be the first show, the beta test, Sunday. You sync your phone up to your TV and to me, and you will hear me commentating exactly as you see it on your TV. No matter where you are, no matter where you're watching, no matter what. You sync up your mic to your TV, and it will sync you up to me through this advanced, crazy technology. There's a huge production team working behind the scenes on the app live to make sure that everybody is synced up. It's fucking nuts, and it's insane, and it's going to be huge. And it debuts for me Sunday at the Royal Rumble with the Hot Mic app, but you should download it now because we are trending now on Hot Mic app, and I am so close to the top right now that it's making me just hard and erect down below. It's on your phone. Download it now. The Hot Mic app. Use the code Cronin. Let's just keep practicing those promos. Let's just keep practicing them over and over again. I'm telling Leah to do it. Leah's like, what are you saying down there? Like, Leah, go get the Hot Mic app, dude. Go get the Hot Mic, man. I can do other games, too. It'll be a lot of fun. Relic, you're going to be at the Rumble? Dude, if you're at the Rumble, you can put headphones on. And listen to me. That's a great point. What if you're at the event? If you're at the event, I'm assuming that you could probably do it. It's got to be a way you can do it. Black Lab 27. What's up, Black Lab? Thank you so much, Patrick Carnes. I'll make 100 accounts. All right. Black Lab has been a badass supporter recently, too. So thank you to Black Lab for that, man. That was a fucking insane experience, blasting Joe Cronin screaming 69 while staying in a checkout line. What a rush. I might get to 69. We need to get to 69 tonight, everybody. Come on. Let's go. We can do it. I'm going to be talking about this on Patreon tomorrow morning during my first episode of Morning Madness since it changed the name to Madness, the Madness Podcast, or whatever the fuck. I don't even give a fuck. The Cocksucking Podcast. We are... I'm still at 56 followers. We got to get to 69. Like, that's got to happen tonight, right? We got to do it. Let me see if I can go over to Dropbox and throw up that video. Did I do it already? Maybe I already did this. I'm drawing blank. I'm having like a stroke. Let's see. What up, GHP? I don't know what you said, though. What's up, John Montgomery? What did John Montgomery say? Yikes, what did she say, Britt Baker trying again? Oh, she just kind of said like...
Britt Baker, trying again.
Yeah, she just... John Montgomery, thanks for the super chat. Yeah, basically, she just kind of said like, you know, you're... What did you do? Like, you know, you worked at Starbucks and... I don't know, it was just really bad. Let me pull it up. Well, I guess I closed it already. But yeah, her promo was not good. I don't remember. I just remember it didn't feel like she put her whole heart into it. You know what I mean? Like it didn't feel really believable. You know? It's very poor. Very poor promo by Britt Baker. She talked kind of like timid heel. Like she didn't know what, like she didn't know if she wanted to just be saying it or something. I don't know. It was just not, it just wasn't done well. I could listen to it word for word and tell you, but I closed my YouTube TV screen already. Just wasn't good enough. That's all I can say. Trust me. What the fuck?
Let's get gay. I want that gay in my face. I want that gay. Let's get gay. It's a party if the gays are
gay. Holy shit!
I love gays. I want gays. I'm not straight. I want gay. I want that gay up in my face.
Oh my god!
Let's get so gay. Let's get so gay. And I love gays in my face.
Fee-fi-foo-fun Joe is sneaking around on my brown bum.
Come on! Holy hell, Black Lab! What the fuck? Black Lab sneaks in at the very end of the show and takes over Hazardous Beard's Digital Championship! Good God Almighty, did you go to bed early? Because you missed the change of champions! Wow. Black Lab 27. What in the world are you doing? Man, he has been beasting lately, but that was a shock. Black Lab. Let's get gay. I want that gay up in my face. I want you to do me, Joe. That's a great profile pic. You're going to have to get banned, though. Black Lab, holy fucking Christ, brother. Thank you for the $69, man. I really appreciate that, man. Whoa. That's more than I make in my morning job. That's more than I make in my other job now. Oh, my God. What in the world? Oh. Wow, man. Thank you so much, dude. What the fuck is going on? Wow. Here's a little bit of Drew right now for you. Black Lab, thanks again, man. That's crazy.
Joe, stop playing that clip.
Crystal sounds amazing there. I would put her in my porn.
What is the context of that?
Oh, yeah.
I basically bust in on her.
Testicle festival.
All right. Relax.
Oh my God, die.
I love my wife.
Oh my God, die.
Leah, do you want to go with me to the car wash?
Oh my God, die.
Oh.
My God, die.
Does YouTube tax me, John Montgomery? No, the government does. The government taxes me. YouTube takes 30% of your super chat. And the government takes 25% of your super chat. So, yeah, if you donate $5 to me, I see about $2. If somebody,
Super Chat Party!
Hit me with that Dre drop. Does YouTube tax you?
The government does.
I'm a fucking idiot!
If you got a dick, I'll follow you.
Ooh, oh, I can come. Ooh.
Yeah, they, so because a donation is considered income, you know what I mean? It's not considered like a donation. It's considered like I'm working for money. It's considered tip. It's considered taxable money. So everything that's ever donated. So if I made $50,000 in tips in donations in a year, you know, YouTube would take 30% of that. If you do Streamlabs, then they only take like 3 or 5% if you add PayPal. So PayPal and Streamlabs and everything total, they take like 5%. So they take 5% of 50,000, whatever that is. I think it's like 2,500 or 5,000. I don't know. Suck at math. But then the government is going to tax me 30%. So take 30% away from 50,000. So they're going to take that money. It's a lot of money. They take a lot of money because it's a lot of straight income. It's not like you're working a job and you get to select what you whatever. It's different. It's a lot of money they take. It's crazy. Thank you for following me on Hot Mic, Edsview. Thank you guys for putting my name down on Hot Mic. Much appreciated, man. Hazardous Beard is here too. Oh, he fucked you over, Hazardous Beard. By the way, that is a hazardous beard. That's a bad beard. I mean, like a badass beard is what I mean. Guys, I'm so excited for Star Trek, man. Hazardous Beard. Your beard is fucking awesome, dude. That is an awesome beard. I love your beard. You got a nice pic, too, with you and your girl and stuff. That's cool. I love families. I don't know, I'm just into families. Thank you for following me on Hot Mic and downloading the Hot Mic app and putting in my code as well. Thank you. And to Black Lab, who's came in and sniped. Black Lab 27 came in and sniped the digital championship away. Out of nowhere at the very end of the night. Crazy. Oh, I guess some of you guys actually DM'd Hot Mike and said that you guys were having problems putting in the code. And they said they're working on it. Shout out to Lewis Money who DM'd them. They responded to him. That's how sick Hot Mike is. Hot Mike is up at 12:50 a.m. right now working on this shit. Can you believe that? Fucking responding to your DMs already? That's crazy. Good shit, man. Not bad. How badass are those guys? And I'm still live, man. We had 800 people earlier. 405, hello.
Hey, what's going on, Joe?
What's up, man?
Nothing, but I'd call, chime in a couple hours away from Star Trek, kind of pick your brain on it for 2 seconds. Don't want to bore everybody to death, though.
Hey, you know what? At this point, anything goes on this show, and I'm hyped for Star Trek, so fuck, whatever.
Yeah, I hear you. I guess my fear is, you know, it's going to be agenda-driven, or maybe just, I guess my biggest fear is just like it not feeling like Star Trek at all or something.
That's,
I kind of get a little of that from the trailers.
Yeah, that's my biggest fear. I mean, it's weird. I get, honestly, from the trailers, I get a vibe of cinema. Like, we're going to see this sort of epic Picard tale told in sort of a cinema-style, movie-style, little saga almost. And I'm not expecting TNG. I'm not expecting that sort of, like, very nice, wholesome crew of, you know, what we knew and everything. I'm not expecting that, so I'm okay with the sort of the darkness. I'm sort of expecting a movie tone, similar to, like, Nemesis or something like that. I'm expecting that, you know.
Yeah, it's got that vibe. It's definitely more of a cinema movie vibe for sure. So that's okay. I can live with that to a point, you know. But, I mean, they're going to have to give us something to make it fill the part, more or less. Like I said, I know it's not going to be the same. I get it. Time's moved on. I just don't, you know, if they could just make me feel like I'm in the same world somewhat, I guess I'll live with it.
Right. That, dude, that's all I want. Like, and if they have a little bit of stuff in it, okay. The one thing I don't want is I don't want them to step backwards, because this is, again, it's supposed to be this more perfect world, but there's always been conflict, even in the, you know, even though they say it's the perfect world. Because I used to think this when I was a kid. Gene Roddenberry talked about how the world was perfect now and humans had moved on and everything. But there was still conflict every second in TNG. Like, they wanted to take Data and take him for parts so they could make more androids and he'd lose himself. You know, there was people right. taking over stuff in the Federation. They had the insurrection episode where the Admiral was there and they wanted to, you know, take the stuff from the planet, from the people. You know, so even... even those things, if those happen nowadays, we would say, oh, this is a message about the elite and the rich and the right and you know, that type of thing. When back then, that's sort of what Star Trek has always been, a little hippie and a little left wing. It's always been that way. So that, if it's like that a little bit with an optimism that's not insulting to people, because it won't really insult me because I kind of am a left leaning person. But when I see them, right. when I do see them insulting people, you know, I don't like that, but I do like when it's a good message. So as long as it's not, like you said, SJW crazy or whatever, like, I'll be okay then. Yeah. You know, I mean, it's...
Yeah, I don't want a, you know, a Star Trek society that felt like a revenge society or, a,
yes.
you know, we're, I don't know. It never felt like that. It always, like, we're better than that. We turn the other cheek.
That, well,
we
no.
seek the high ground, basically.
That's exactly what you're saying. You're right. It's not a revenge. In Star Trek, it was if somebody was wrong or if somebody was being bad or if somebody was being selfish or somebody was being whatever, there was always sort of a, like, let's convince them not to do that, or let's show them
yeah,
why.
There was a lesson in it. A lesson is what I kind of got from it.
Yeah, you didn't, like, hope the guy dies and then, like, ha-ha, like, we got you. Like, there was a sort of, yeah, there was, like, a middle ground to be resolved or whatever. Yeah, so it was like the example I gave on Discovery. When the white male guy was randomly just mean to Michael, the character, she's a black female, and he's just,
right.
In the second season at the beginning, he's like, oh, yeah, you're going to do real good at whatever. And he's, like, basically thinks, like, she can't fly because she's a woman or whatever. And it's like, dude, this is the future in Star Trek. People aren't...
Yeah, we're beyond that.
Yeah, what the hell? Why is this happening? And then when the guy dies, they're like, ha-ha, like, he deserved to die, like, type of thing. It's like, what?
Yeah, almost like we've regressed a little bit or something.
Yeah, and it's kind
of
like...
Back to a point of where we are now. And I get they have to relate to where we are now. But there still has to be that something that makes you understand that this is bigger and better than where we are in some aspect, I guess.
Yeah. And so if there's that, then I'll be okay. So I'm hoping I like what I see. I don't like what I'm hearing. You know, there's a lot of people. But, you know, a lot of people did this with Star Trek, with Star Wars. They were like,
right.
Oh, it's not going to be good. It's so bad. And I saw it. And, yeah, as a movie, it's not a good movie, but I was entertained by it. It was a cop-out because of what they had to do, but at least it wasn't as bad to me as a lot of the people were saying. Like, going into Last Jedi, I thought it was going to be awesome, and everybody was saying it was great, and then I thought it was crazy. Going into this one, I was going into the new Star Wars, I was like, oh, everyone says it sucks, and I thought, oh, it's all right, but it's kind of weird.
Yeah. It's been exciting, though, to at least have it to look forward to. So, you know, if it's all right, I'm going to be all of that, good with that. I'm not going to shit on it, you know. If it's middle ground, you know, I'll live with that. Because just kind of the thought of it being back in the talk with people and things like that, it's kind of cool. So, you know, we'll see what we get. But I wanted to pick your brain a little bit before it happens. I was the one that hit you up on Twitter with the time they say it's supposed to be on, like middle of the night or something. I don't know how accurate that really is. I just...
But yeah,
we'll see. But yeah, I'm ready for it.
I when I messaged the CBS people, they said 3:05 by 3:05, and now. So I mean, dude, I'm gonna be up. I'm probably can't sleep. I'm gonna have to watch it. I can't deal with it.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I'm off tomorrow, so I'm all good. So yeah, I'm gonna have my popcorn ready. So we'll see how it plays out. But man, I'll call you back maybe tomorrow or something. We'll see how it is, and you know, compare notes, and you know, fingers crossed, man, we get a good show.
What do you think's up with Data? You think, like, because I said right way at the beginning, I was like, I bet you he's on the holodeck. But so do you think?
I said that. I told my son the exact same thing earlier. I said, what if he's the holodeck, a holographic character? That I could live with that, because theoretically that could be possible, I guess,
right.
You know? So, I mean, maybe, I don't know. It'd kind of make the movie pointless if he's, you know, back, and do they just reassembled his remains and he's all good. So that would be a little weird, but I guess I could turn, you know,
well, they
as long
still,
as it's not dumb, I'll be all right.
You know, they still had the memories of the copy of Data that they put into B4,
right.
So that could happen. But,
he'd be B4. We'll see what happens. So, yeah, like I said, man, just fingers crossed. We're going to see what happens. It's not too much longer now.
Yeah, I can't wait to talk about it tomorrow, so I will definitely be around. I'll be messaging about it and tweeting about it or something, because I'll be hyped up. I'm going to – hopefully Leo, my wife, will watch it with me, too, because I kind of want to watch it with her, too, because she's, like me, a big she grew up on Star Trek, so she loves it too. So
yeah, I mean, I'm envious of you. My wife, she just never, you know, some people don't get it, and you know, she's never been a Star Wars, Star Trek-y type person.
Yeah.
So she don't get it. So I'm kind of alone in my house. I've got a younger kid now, though. He doesn't hate it, so you know, it gives me somebody to watch it with.
Like, yeah, I always thought, my kids are gonna love it. My kids don't really. My kids sit down and do watch it sometimes with me. But yeah, they don't love it yet, but they just kind of watch it. They don't hate it either. It's the same way. Like I'm trying to get them to love it more or whatever. But
yeah, I think the older they get, the more if you can expose them to it, they'll appreciate it. Because when there comes a certain age, you'll get it.
Right. I think I lost you. Oh yeah, I think we lost your phone there. But man, appreciate the call and fingers crossed that Picard is good tonight. AJ Sandwich, yeah, I gave it a 7 out of 10 tonight for AEW. We did the review already. You got to go back to the beginning to watch it. We're just in post-show. I'm just kind of talking with you guys right now. Did I hit 69 followers on the Hot Mic app? Did I get 69 followers on the Hot Mic app? Guys, make sure when you download the Hot Mic app on iPhone or Android that you put in the promotional code or Cronin or how you heard about us, you enter in Cronin, C-R-O-N-I-N. Do it now. I'm going to be live on the Hot Mic app in front of so many people Sunday night for the Royal Rumble. It's going to be huge. Hot Mic app. Let me go see if I get 69 followers. Joe Cronin's coming to the Hot Mic app Sunday at the Royal Rumble. Google Play and Apple Store. Poopy Pants. The fucking Hot Mic app. Let's see if I hit 69. Oh, the hot mic app are saying it's fixed. We pushed an update 45 minutes ago. We had a space in which the code screen didn't show up. It says Hot Mic. Oh, so they just happened to not have the code screen show up while you guys were all signing up. Are you serious? So everybody, make sure you guys log in, log out, try again to put in the code Cronin on your Hot Mic app. And thank you guys for getting us near goal. Tonight, we have a 9-day goal. For the rest of the month, we're trying to hit 1,000 by the end of the month.
Super chat.
We're getting there. Thank you guys for that tonight.
If Barstool Sports and Apple asked you to work for them covering WWE, but Apple says they will double whatever Barstool offers, which one you take?
Oh, man, I don't know. That's a tough one, John Montgomery. Probably Barstool, because Barstool would, like, I could do whatever I wanted over there. They would never get rid of me. They wouldn't give a shit. But Apple might fire me for something. So I'm not sure. So I guess you guys have to update Hot Mic, I suppose. I suppose there's an update. So you might have to update Hot Mic, sign out, sign back in, or re-sign up completely, maybe. I don't know. Give it a try. It's a good way to support the show, but it's also, you're going to want to be there Sunday. Oh, yeah, they're showing an update, yeah. Yep, so they updated. Oh, shit, we got to 69, guys. We got 69, baby. Woo! Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby. Eat my asshole. Oh, the promo code worked for you, Dan H. and Cora. What up, Cora? And Dan. Mr. Dan! You got my name. And by the way, Dan backwards is Nad. I'm going to share the shit out of Hot Mic tomorrow. Thanks, man. Also, guys, check out my friend Chris Hall in Stabbing Westward. Stabbing Westward just released their new EP, Dead and Gone. And Chris Hall told me he's really excited about all of how pumped up everybody was. But, you know, now it's sort of getting to that point where it's dying down a little bit. All the fans have bought everything. So if you're new to Stabbing Westward or if you're a former Stabbing Westward listener back in the 90s, their new EP is available right now. Go check that out. You guys can buy it digitally for $5 on Bandcamp. Go to stabbingwestward.com. You can enter a you can buy a physical CD. You can buy the digital copy on Bandcamp. Leave them a note. Tell them I sent you. Buy it and say, hey, Joe Cronin, I heard you on Joe Cronin, blah, blah, whatever the fuck. Buy it on Bandcamp. If you guys want to support a band that, you know, whatever. A lot of you guys probably don't like that music, but some of you might. So if you do, cool. And if you're somebody who didn't even know they were back, then even cooler. I'm promoting everything tonight. I don't fucking know what to do. What's up, everybody? Sam Squatch Rivera, what's going on? I think we need a campaign for Barstool Sports. Yeah, dude, I would love to be on Barstool Sports. The articles I would write on that website, the podcasts I would do on that stream, the streams I would do on Barstool Sports, dude, I would fuck someone's ass. Hey, Ed Blunt, go fuck yourself, bro. Ed Blunt, buy my dick, bro. Are you buying this right now? It's all free for you. It's all free for you, Ed Cunt. Fucking Ed Cunt. What's up, Ed? How you been, you fucker? How's your mom's pussy? Is the real question. That's the real question. Hey, Drew, how you feel about this?
Ooh. Oh, I can't come. Ooh.
My God. Die.
Oh, come on, Leah.
My God. Die.
Oh, my God. Die. I will have the entire interview with Chris Hall up later on my other channel, so... Probably only a few of you guys will be interested in that, but it was a fun talk that I had with Chris, so it's cool. Got a little bit of it right here. Chris, do you even a lot of the stuff you've done over the years has been more of like to keep doing music, to keep doing art, to because I'm like this, I think that way, and I'd always think, man, what's going
on? So, yeah. Yeah, I did. Otherwise, it's literally a chain at that point. And so I was like, so the director's like, okay, you know, he's like, I don't mind. The director was honestly like, everyone's kind of sick of seeing bands pretend to play in a warehouse or in a field or whatever. You know, like everyone's seen that video. Let's make something, you know, really cool.
Great to talk to Chris Hall. It will be up late at some point later on the other channel. I'm going to have, I'm basically going to be releasing a whole bunch of band interviews at once, so I'm trying to get them all recorded. We got Chibi coming on from The Birthday Massacre. We got Sean Danielson from Smile, Empty Soul. We got Chris Hall from Stabbing Westward and The Dreaming. We're going to have Dave Grohl on the fucking show. That's going to be huge. The only person that I haven't recorded the interviews yet is Dave Grohl and Chibi from Birthday Massacre. I've got Sean Danielson. I've got Chris Hall. I've got... the guy from, oh God, what's it called? Why am I drawing a blank? It's a new industrial band that I really like. And we're really working right now on trying to get a quick one with the guys from Rammstein, as Rammstein is coming to America. Rammstein is coming to America on an American tour, and they're coming to fucking Boston! They're only coming to like 7 places in America. I think it's like L.A. and somewhere down south and Florida, maybe Chicago. I don't know. But they're coming to Boston and New York. Party.
We all need to tweet Dave Portnoy hire Joe Cronin.
Is that the Barstool Sports guy? A lot of people want me over there. A lot of people want me to do a show over there. People always want Sirius Satellite Radio. I don't know. Dude, we would have killed it if we got on there. We would blow that station up. We would blow Sirius Satellite Radio up. I mean, we wouldn't actually blow it up, but we'd rejuvenate that goddamn company. They need some new blood over there. Let me tell you that. That place needs some new blood because they got problems over at Sirius. They do. They've got Howard Stern. He's like 900. And, you know, we all grew up listening to Howard in the 90s. We all love Howard. I love Howard, too. But it's not the same show. Opie and Anthony are dead, you know. Anthony's got a great Compound Media channel. I spoke to Anthony about 6 months ago. I spoke to the guys from Compound. I spoke to Anthony. And we just couldn't really figure out a way to make something special over there with them. So I don't know. I don't know if I'll still decide to do that, but I am in talks with them, but we just can't figure out what to do that would be special. So, I don't know. But I do like Compound, and I do like Anthony, and I do like all the guys over there. Stern is an SJW now, yeah. Did I block Mad Dog? Yeah, I did. That guy was like probably a troll. pretty sure I know. I'm pretty sure he was like a troll guy. He always writes weird shit. It's all bad stuff usually. Why, Ed? Are you a troll too? Is that like your alt account? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Super Chat.
What's up, Matt?
Party.
Dave is the Bastille CEO. He's a Boston guy, too.
Yeah, I just looked him up. Yeah, I remember him. Yeah, I actually know somebody that knows that guy, actually. I didn't know that he was still the CEO, though. I thought he left. For some reason, I don't know why. Yeah, they're all Boston guys. It's a Boston deal, you know? It'd be really easy to work there. But, yeah. Hot mic is getting hot. Yeah, we're at 70. Not bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. I'm the 24th most popular guy on hot mic right now. Come on. Come on, baby. Come on. What are we doing? What are we doing on hot mic? The app. The brand new app. Coupon code Cronin.
What else we got?
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Britt Baker is the only woman on the division I like. I just hope she works on her promos because that was bad.
I agree, Broken Lion. Yeah. It was really bad, Broken Lion. What up, Broken Lion? What's up, dude? Good to hear from you, man. What's up? I love you, dude. Man, I fucking love Broken Lion. I wish I could. I want to give you a hug and a beer. It really was bad, man. It just was not good. I didn't believe her. I didn't believe that she's a heel or she's a bad lady. I didn't believe it. I did not believe it. Joe Dogs, you like Star Trek Discovery? Nah, man. Star Trek Discovery has major problems. I think if you eliminated some of the SJWE stuff into it a little bit and you eliminated the stuff that just wasn't Star Trek, that stuff really pisses me off. The stuff that's not Star Trek really aggravates me. So that pisses me off. But what I can say positive about Discovery is Discovery Season 1 has an ending that is one of the best swerve endings or one of the best swerves at the end of the season in any show I've ever seen in my entire life. And if you're somebody who watched TNG, Enterprise, Voyager, and Deep Space Nine, and the original series, if you're somebody who watched all of the previous Star Treks, there's something at the end of Season 1 of Discovery that is fucking awesome. It is one of the best swerves and tie-ins that I've ever seen. And honestly, it is pretty fucking awesome. So as shitty as Discovery is, and as not Star Trek as so much of it is, that part was a really Star Trek tie-in that was really cool. And even if it wasn't Star Trek, just like, oh my God. Like if you're not a Star Trek fan and you watch it, it's still a swerve at the end. It's a swerve. And you're like, oh wow, like that's crazy. But if you're a Star Trek fan who watches Star Trek, the swerve at the end is that is so amazing to me. Like, it's really good. Like, that was so fucking well done. I can't believe it. But everything else is, there's so many other problems with it that it's the worst Star Trek series of all time to me. It's the worst one. And that's what makes Discovery bad, is the fact that there's alien fucking, like the fucking Klingons are naked fucking somebody, like people are getting murdered and swears. I can't watch Discovery with my kids. Star Trek is supposed to be a fucking, like, mostly family show. I like it. I don't want to see the aliens' tits and pussy while she gets fucked and then people getting their faces cut open. It's basically Game of Thrones meets Star Trek. That's what it is. They were like, we want to do Game of Thrones. What do we have, Star Trek? Sorry, it's not Star Trek. Discovery is bad. I would say, In my opinion, like, my favorite Star Trek is TNG. I would say that, for me, it's TNG and then Enterprise. I actually like Enterprise one of the best, which is retarded. I can't believe I'm saying that, but, you know, it's like TNG, Enterprise, the original series, Deep Space Nine, Voyager, and Discovery's last. Discovery is definitely last.
Super Chat Party!
Looks amazing.
Joe, on a larger audience night, we are going to make that higher Joe Cronin tweet to Dave Portnoy. You would be perfect for it. Double down.
Alrighty. Well, hey, just keep hitting him up every day, I guess. Keep email him, tweet him, whatever. Email him, tweet him, tell him all the thousands of listeners and the support. I don't fucking know. Tell him, yeah, sure, go for it, man. Hey, get me on over there. I mean, dude, I've gotten promotions and offers and sponsorships before just because of you guys. It's no doubt. That's how I ended up working with so many other people. So anything you guys want to do to pump it up, that's fucking awesome. I mean, nobody gets the support I get, like, that you guys give me. It's crazy. But, yeah, I don't really talk about the other stuff, but I'm just doing so much in the world right now. It's crazy. You know, and then I'm doing the kids stuff in the day and cleaning up, and then I'm working at another job now, and then I'm doing my job here like I have been, like, crazy with stuff. So I am full bore, like, busy. I am really so, like, more busy than anyone even knows at this point. But luckily, I'm very lucky to have a lot of time with my kids, too. I can take, you know, I can help my kids in the morning. I can tuck my kids in at night and read them a story really quickly. I can spend 2 hours with them in the day playing and stuff with them. I can watch something for Leah, go out for Leah, whatever. And then today I did the interview with Stabbing Westward, which was an hour and a half. I did an interview with another guy. I created a couple little videos, but for the most part, I was doing all that other shit. I was working my other job, too, which is, like, part-time, 6 days a week. So there's, like, so many things now that I'm doing, but I'm more behind in things than I've ever been right now, I feel like. So it's just been crazy. But yeah, I don't want to talk about it because I don't want to get into it. I don't want to talk about it, but because I'll be seen as like a whiner or somebody who's asking for something. So like, I just won't do it. But the bottom line is I've been really busy. That's why I look like I'm dead all the time, I think. I think that's why I look like I'm dead all the time. Yeah, I remember War of the Worlds, Patrick Carnes. I do remember that. I think you showed me the old videos of that too at one point. Don't show it to Clover, Joe. A larger audience night. Yeah, John Montgomery. Thank you for that donation too, John Montgomery. Yeah, I think Picard is on Netflix if you're outside the U.S. So people listening right now in the U.K. and everywhere else. I think Star Trek Picard's going to be on Netflix. And for everybody else, if anybody has any more feedback about Hot Mike, I'm going to be talking to them tomorrow. So feel free to give me feedback for Hot Mike. So I'm going to talk to the CEO and the other guys tomorrow probably. So let me know if you have any questions or comments or suggestions. If you have suggestions, questions, or comments about Hot Mike since you've been on the app tonight, please let me know, because I will ask them tomorrow what you guys have been asking about here. Sunday on the Hot Mic app, Joe Cronin is live. Yeah, it's going to be great. First time broadcasting. It's their first ever WWE broadcast, by the way. They've done all these football games. They've done tons of sporting events. They've never done WWE before, so it is the full-on beta test. It's going to be huge Sunday night. Just make sure you guys download the app, put in the code Cronin, the promotional code Cronin, or how did you hear about us, coupon code, whatever it is, Cronin, C-R-O-N-I-N, and then follow me. It's going to be big. Hot mic, baby. Let's go. Connor versus that Russian guy is the next Joe to fight. What? Connor versus the Russian guy? That Russian guy is huge. He's not fighting Connor. What are you talking about? That guy was humongous. Are you talking about Khabib or whatever? I thought you were talking about the Russian guy who like sat on that dude and won the fight the other day. There was a lot of stuff going down on that UFC fight. Hey, it's too bad Hot Mike didn't get a hold of me for the UFC fight, because that was a huge event. There was like, we had 100,000 people come in. YouTube took away half the views, though, because anybody who re-clicked on it, they don't count it as a view, I think, so it went down to 60,000. But according to my analytics, we had 100,000 people stop in during the UFC thing. It was a big deal. It's a fun time. You guys are fucking beasts. Vince McMahon's nuts smell money. Smell like money. Damn it, yeah. Hey, we got to shout out our top donator tonight. He took it from the bearded one, Black Lab 27. Speaking of Black Labs, Black Lab, my Black Lab, poor Melly, man. Melly hates Clover. Like, she's so disgusted by Clover. Like, get away from me. I tweeted this out earlier today. This is just my dog, man. The poor fucking dog. Melly, Clover just wants to play with Melly so bad, and Melly wants nothing to do with her. And Melly just, like bites at her to get her away, and, like, Clover's just like, I love you. I love you. Check this out. This fucking poor dog. What I owe is a balance, and what she owes as a balance of 500. This is Clover trying to play with Melly. Melly, get away from me. 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 I just want to play, though. I just want to play, though. Come on, I'm Clover. I just want to play. Get away from me. Get away from me. I just want to play. Come on. Don't you want to play with me? Come on. I just want to play. I just want to play, Melly. Come on. Come on, Melly. Don't you want to just play with me? Come on. I'm going to get up here with you. I'm going to get up here. Get away from me. All right, that's it. I'm getting out of here. Get out of here. I'm getting away. Well, come on. I'm up. Where are you going? Oh, man, Clover just follows Melly around everywhere. And Melly's like, get the fuck away from me.
Melly, why won't you be nice to her? Melly, be nice to her. Come on. Get down, Clover. Clover. Get down. Get down, good girl. Get down. Get down.
So how much beyond... What payments did you make? How much did you make in payments towards the car?
$450 total between
three payments. Get away from me. Get away from me. I love this. Like, get away from me. Finn's just eating a popsicle. You put $1,000 down. Get away from me. I just want to play with you. Get away from me. This goes on every day, constantly. It's like, poor fucking Melly. But also poor Clover. Come on, Melly. Get on there, Melly. Black Lab's bullshit. Oh, my God. Melly is racist. Melly is racist. Confirmed. Oh, my God. Actually, Leah was watching Court TV. I was just sitting down for a minute while she was doing something, and then I went downstairs and started working. Nice sectional, yeah. You paid for it. No, I just kidding. But no, it was pretty cool. We got a gift. We got a lot of gifts. We got a lot of gifts from a lot of people, obviously. Finn is just chilling. Finn is actually sick. He's kind of sick right now, so he was really sad just kind of sitting by himself, hanging out. Yeah, Clover's really big now. Clover is a big girl now. Yeah, I don't think I have anything more to say. I guess it's time to wrap up and hope that... what's up, Trenton? And hope that Picard is good tonight. Star Trek Picard is good. I already purchased CBS All Access again. So you have to pay $9.99 for CBS All Access to watch it. So John Montgomery paid for my CBS All Access tonight. Thank you. By himself. Yeah, I was running upstairs a lot today helping with Finn. Finn just kept... There was at one point today where he just wanted me. He didn't, like... He was like, oh, I love mommy. He usually loves mommy. That's all he ever wants is mommy, mommy, mommy. And mommy helps him and stuff. But tonight... thank you, Black Lab, so much, man. But tonight, there was a point where he wanted daddy. So... he came down and just wanted dad, so, you know, I hung out with him at that point. He's a little cute redhead, man. He's a little funny redhead. I love this little guy. Look at his red hair, man. He's just the funniest little guy. If I'm having the worst day, it's like, thankfully I have these kids that are just the best. It's the best time, man. This is the best time. I waited for this my whole life to have a family, so this is great. It really is great. You know, one of my best memories was back at the AEW show, by the way, which I think I got to upload still, my experience at AEW, because I got to hang out with all these guys. These are all the guys that I used to know in school, and most of us would all do the backyard wrestling stuff, and they all went together to the AEW show. And got a box up in the box area. Luckily, I had a press pass, and I was down close to the ring, and I was able to go wherever I wanted to in the building. So I went up and hung out with them for a little while, and I just had a fucking roaring of a time, or a fucking crazy time with these crazy bastards that I went to school with. So that's Gooey B. A long time ago, Gooey called my show as Boss N-Word. I don't even know if you can say the N-word anymore on YouTube after what happened to Heist Man the other day. So, Boss N-word, we'll say. Long time he called as if he was him. That was back in 2009 or 2008. He called my show pretending to be Boss N-word in front of 9 listeners. It's amazing. He's hilarious. You nervous about having kids? No, I think you'll like it, bro. Hot Mike, Reckless Jeff, what's up? Yeah, my daughter's fine. Yeah, she's okay. Thanks, man. After the hospital trip, she's been good. Can't even see anything on her hair. I think this is after she got hit in the head. No, this isn't. This is before that. Yeah, so she didn't have a scar there anyway. Yeah, she was fine. Her head was okay. Her head was fine. Let's see here. Hey, you guys remember my buddy Brad? I told you he was the one who said about my ex-girlfriend, he was like, I'm gentle, when we were laying in the bed. And she was like, oh, he'd be too rough for me. And he goes, I'm gentle, and he's all quiet. That joke I was telling you guys about, I might have been on Corrupted Podcast. I don't remember. But anyway, I do have a picture of him. This is that guy. This is literally Brad. He's like, I'm gentle. That's him. That's literally him right there. And then I'm high out of my mind in the background. I'm not actually not high. I just look high. I just always look high. Dude, I'm like, yo, I'm just baked. What's up, man? I'm baked. How you doing? I'm baked back here. I look like I'm fucked up. I look like I'm fucked out of my mind right there. But I'm not. I'm just fucking look like that. I look jacked up. Dude, this is why no wonder Leah likes that I put pubes on my face. Me and the horror king Vinny Marcellia, when I was calling one of his matches, and then we got hammered and then beat up an old man in a parking lot. And then we took pictures of the whole thing. Man, I am clean face. This was 2019. This is April 2019, and I look like I am clean face right there. I am clean as shit right there. And Vinny Marcellia looks like he's an idiot. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, fuck him. It's me and Justin Roberts. I put Justin Roberts in a headlock during WrestleCon, and we took a picture of him in a headlock, and then fucking I deleted the picture by accident. And it's bullshit, because like we spent all this time making the weirdest face, too. We had a was it Mick Foley? No, it was Al Snow was making fun of us, because he's like, what are you guys doing? And I'm like, well, I'm putting him in a headlock. And Al Snow is like, it looks like he's trying to suck your nipples. And I'm like, well, he probably is. He's fucking thirsty for milk. You know, at this time, Justin Roberts hadn't been hired by AEW yet. And, you know, he was thirsty for milk, is what Justin Roberts. By the way, check out Justin Roberts' book. It's still available right now. It's a great book. Called The Action for a while. It's a good book. Good guy. Look at this picture. Look at JD.
Hit me with that crystal moan. Oh, welcome, Tommy.
John Montgomery.
Joe, stop playing that clip.
Crystal sounds amazing there. I would put her in my porn.
What is the context of that?
Oh, yeah.
I basically bust in on her.
Oh, God. I basically bust in on her. That's just so wrong. Here's me and Leah at SmackDown. Shout out to the Road Dog. Thanks, Road Dog. My wife enjoyed the front row. She also, that was the one where we were on the opening too of SmackDown. That was fun. We were like, we were part of that big wide shot that they peeled up on. That was great. That was pretty cool. That was a good time. Let's just reminisce on shit with photos. This is Sexy Jesus getting his tits rubbed by Big Bacon Brad Hollister. And I'm in the background staring at a guy's ass right there. I'm staring at a guy's ass right there. That's what I'm doing. That's what's happening. That's legit what's happening. This is me threatening to shoot Tommy, NC, and JD. That's me threatening to shoot Tommy, NC, and JD. For the people that always wonder about our heights, this is a pretty good representation, I guess. Right? That's a pretty good representation of our heights. Me and Tommy are basically the same size. You know, he's standing straight up here, and I'm leaning a little bit to the left. So you can see our eyes are pretty close, you know, sized up. And he's wearing combat boots, and I don't think I have shoes on here. So, but yeah, you can see how me and Tommy are basically the same height. But you can see how JD is much smaller, right? That's fucked up. That's fucked up. Poor JD. I'm kidding, man. I used to think that I could not go on. If I could be it, then I could see it. It's one of my favorite times of all time, talking to good old JR. We had a fucking blast. Had a great time with JR. Now, I held up my fist and I said, you know, it sucks because you have a Hall of Famer ring. I don't have a ring. This is bullshit, JR. Why do I not have a ring like you? My hand is so much bigger than yours, JR. I said that to JR. I said, my hand is so much bigger than yours. You know, and I was basically saying to JR, you know, I, you know, JR, I'm a wrestler. You know, JR, you're just making barbecue sauce. You know, and I said, you know, that's why my fist is so much bigger than yours, you know, Jim. And, you know, Jim agreed. He also said, you know, why do you have these wolf pubes on your face? To me, he also said that. This was the day I got married last October. This was a very happy day. Can't get up. Oh, look at that. I look like we just got investigated for like tax fucking evasion or something. Like we both look like we're shocked here that there's a photo being taken. Like I look like I just got married. That's what I look like. I look like, oh fuck, what did I do? Like now legally it's all hers. Like I fucked up. But no, I was wicked happy actually. And we have some good photos of us actually smiling, but I was really happy. I was like super happy. Like, that was a fucking awesome day. This is me and Wolf. If you guys ever remember my gaming streams with SW Wolf, this is my buddy Wolf. Can't get a picture where he shows us together. But yeah, we're being weird. And that's Wolf and me blowing each other. Anyway, I think that's about it for those photos. It was a lot of fun. What just happened? Who just messaged me? I'm just killing time waiting for Picard. Oh, yeah. I remember when I said keep it family friendly and busted my mouth open. Oh, God. That was funny. Let me see if I can find it. I thought somebody made a video out of that. Maybe not, though. Yeah, I thought it was, I thought I had it, but I guess not. I probably got it somewhere. Just don't know where. We always like to keep it family friendly. This is me calling some event somewhere. I don't know where I was, what I was calling here. I don't know what the show was. Not really sure what the show was. Got that goofy necklace on though. Oh, this was me calling Summer Showdown. I had a blast calling Summer Showdown. The bell is all jacked up. Oh, look at the bell is just, this bell is in some shape, man. Look, I got a Pepsi, a Dunkin' Donuts cup, gum, water, and a beer all right there. That's all my drinks. Because you know the wrestlers are going to take some of them. Someone's going to get smashed with a beer at some point later. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Can we talk about how I look hammered in this photo? Can we talk about how I look drunk as shit in the ring right here? I look like, just give me the mic. I got it right here. I'm fucked up looking. Oh, this was after he touched my balls. He touched me in the privates. This is me doing my job. Sometimes my job is to vacuum the ring. You know, sometimes you gotta vacuum the ring. Oh, Awandi found it. Awandi found it. Awandi found me smashing my mouth open. Do you guys remember this from Monetize This or whatever episode I played this on? I decided to dive into the, and I smacked the mic into my tooth and I busted my mouth wide open, and I continued to announce the wrestlers coming out with a bleeding lip.
Massachusetts, we are inching closer and closer to tonight's week's main event, but I want to remind you real quick that we always like to keep it.
Dude, the only problem is this part, the Monetize This episode has the whole clip, so I got to find where it is on Monetize This, because the whole clip is hilarious. Family friendly. One of the things they always like to say at Top Rope Promotions is, we always keep it family friendly. And basically, these guys in the corner were saying stuff like really loud, like, fuck you, you faggot, and stuff like that. And it was like, oh my god, dude, there's like kids everywhere, you know, and they're getting, the owner, like, wherever's getting mad. So when I went to tell them, we always like to keep it family friendly, please keep it family friendly, so instead of doing that, I go, we always like to keep it, and then I stopped and I ran to the corner to look them in the eye as I said it. So then I dove into the corner, because that's where they were, and stared out at them, family friendly. But when I dove into the corner, the mic bumped the buckle a little bit and then hit me in the teeth and the face. And my whole teeth here went numb, and I had a big hole in my lip, and I started bleeding all over myself afterwards. It's fucking hilarious. It's like the dumbest thing like anyone's ever done. It's got to be.
We are inching closer and closer to tonight's main event, but I want to remind you real quick that we always like to keep it.
Oh my god. Family friendly. Oh my good god, dude. Wandy. Oh man. Dun 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 dun. Holy shit. You look like a gay principal. Oh my god, Relic. Oh my god, dude. I've always wondered. I'm like, I look so lame like in a suit at these wrestling things. Like, I'm such a great fucking like commentator, backstage dork, like dork type of guy. I can really play that shit because I look like exactly like it. And I was trying to think of what I look like. You look like a gay principal. Holy shit. That's it. I've always been wondering, what do I look like? I look like something just weird or something. Gay principal. That's it. You nailed it. Why did I do that? Because I just told you why. It made no sense, really. But I was just being weird. No, no, it's I'm fucking weird. Family friendly. All right, let's go watch some of my AEW vlog and remember that before I put up the whole thing.
This is Wardlow from AEW, and you're watching The Joe Cronin Show.
A wrestling podcast with attitude.
Yeah, we're here at AEW, man. This is the first time ever being to an AEW event, so I'm pretty pumped up. Wait a minute, Brooklyn, New York, and White Sox? You're, like, terrifying me.
No, right? I'm... It's the Glory Boys.
Private Party.
We're outside the Aganis Arena right now with Dan Kennedy. Whoa, Dan, whoa, Kennedy. Hey, Dan, I just cornholed Tommy NC's mother.
I bet you did.
No, no, your line is whoa.
Whoa.
Yeah, come on, man. What the hell? Back down, Janela! Oh, maybe not. Whoa. No, I'm just kidding. I'm joking. But seriously, we have, so far, we've been just, we basically been outside of the Aganis Arena, heckling the shit out of people. We just made fun of a guy who was wearing skinny jeans. Like, there's another guy right there. I can almost see his ass through his pants.
This is Wardlow from AEW.
Back down, Janela!
Oh!
Oh, maybe not! Whoa. No, I'm just kidding. I'm joking, but seriously, we have so far we've been just we basically been outside of the Aganis Arena heckling the shit out of people. We just made fun of a guy who was wearing skinny jeans. Like, there's another guy right there. I can almost see his ass through his pants. I don't know why, but guys now are wearing. Have you noticed this around here? A lot of the guys are jogging around in like the shortest shorts you've ever seen in your life.
Yeah, that's why I don't come out here that much.
Yeah. Have you found yourself doing what I do, especially with the ones who are like completely hairless? I'm like, ooh, look at. Oh, wait. Oh, like I. I just said it 2 minutes ago, and there they go. I think it's a girl.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and there was one guy with calves like Goldberg's muscles.
Oh, you gotta remember with the people with the long hair.
Yeah.
Doing that too, you can't tell.
Yeah, you get a nice blonde, long-haired guy, and it just said, man, I'll tell you what, if you haven't looked at a woman in a while, you think about it. We're thinking about guys right here with Dan Kennedy in front of the Aganis Arena outside of AEW right now. Chris Jericho told Dan Kennedy to go fuck himself earlier. That was crazy. No, it didn't really happen, but he did say something. What did he say to you?
He told me, I asked him for an autograph, and he said, go get Jungle Boy's autograph.
Yeah, go get Jungle Boy. Because Jungle Boy's a whore, right?
And then he flipped me off.
And then he flipped you off, yeah. See, Jungle Boy is a known whore in the wrestling world. No one is a ring rat. They call him the jungle rat. Like, it's crazy. Let me say, so I'm here with Dan again, and so you're going to be like my bodyguard, man. Like, so if anybody in this bar we're going into, you know, tries to fuck me or something like that, you know, you're going to beat them up. If anybody tries to have, like, intercourse with me.
That's basically how it will go.
Amazon Prime. It's me, Ryback. Bring me my... Wait, no! Where are you going? No! What the hell? What? Whoa, look at the girls on that truck right there. Oh, my God. Finish in it.
I've been to a Cubs game too.
So, shout out to the Metro in Chicago.
Yeah, I like Chicago teams, but yeah, I also like Boston teams. I'm going to a Celtics game, a Bruins game next month. Washington.
There's a lot of death in Chicago, though.
Washington.
Yeah. Who says they already are?
Connor from OK Fame.
This is the fourth event I've seen Connor at. Fourth? I think. Maybe third or fourth? I don't know.
You've done like what? NXT, SmackDown? Yeah, it's like the third or fourth.
With all my people. Dude, I ran into somebody earlier who was like, Joe! And then after, like, we took pictures and stuff, he was like, oh, well, I'm going home. Take a big photo.
Yeah.
We are live on top of the whole entire arena.
So, yeah, what's up, man? I mean, you got questions? Or do you want me to just scare people? Somebody, like a bus is getting off right now. Want to just describe the people as they get off the bus? Like, here comes another guy who looks like maybe a shooter. Like, I don't know.
Oh, shit.
That's messed up. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God.
Apologize to anybody whose family's dead.
Oh, my dad's dead. God.
This is a horrible way to start this.
Yeah.
Highlights you have that are worth anything are yours with me.
And it was all in the plan of once. Oh, a shot to the back. I'm surprised Scotty B isn't out here, but they signed this match to vacations, though. Oh, a kick to the face. Cronin goes...
Super. No, that's
unbelievable.
And I would have beat your ass if I didn't get a run in.
Yeah, you've seen this guy before. He's someone said, who's that albino midget? That's Gooey right there. And he's in good shape still.
Still?
I am not in good shape, I will
say
that. But I'll get in shape if I have to.
You're going to have to get in shape in the next 10 seconds. You're
Hey, wait a minute. Hey, hold this. Just take me.
Just take me. You're gonna piss off the thing? Your cock wasn't out. Did you just piss yourself?
Pulling away. Caleb's still standing. He's got the steel chair. Oh, Cronin just got waffled. And he's laid out. Oh, Cronin. Oh, Cronin!
Not mid. Oh my god, no, look out!
I have sucked off everybody in this box. I've sucked off everybody in this box. Him.
Me by force.
Look at that sexy shirt.
Soundwave 92.
He's going to slam dunk.
Soundwave 92.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Those keys. I made these guys.
He's reincarnated Finn Balor.
He's going
reincarnated
off right
Finn Balor.
It's random.
Riho ain't shit, bro. Fuck Riho. Put
God
me on the Joe
it.
Cronin show. I this love Joe Cronin. Yo, put it over here. Hey, put Joe up. Cronin's lovely face over here. Hey, Tommy. Stay positive, bro. I comment you all
me
the time.
Too.
I love you, Tommy. I thought it
all
the
time.
Joe Cronin kisses.
I'm in love with him. I'm in love with him. Oh my god, what is happening? I'm
oh
gay.
God,
I'm gay now.
On her. Oh
I
my kissed
god.
Joe Cronin on the cheek.
Oh my god, he bought he semen stained this t-shirt right
okay,
here.
Right,
that's
bro.
Soundwave. That's Soundwave.
Only 92. This is the Soundwave 92 tuning in right now.
Well, straight. I'll tell you what, Soundwave. You know what I did to Soundwave
the
right
do the he's, Stone Cold do the Stone Cold
but well, he's Soundwave 92, but I gave him a 69 earlier. How about that?
Oh, baby, you know I love the magic.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh. You still won't
appall.
Oh, my God, dude. That's only the half of it. I will get that up, guys, so that premieres for you guys. I never put it up. What am I doing? I'm going to put it up so it's up for you tomorrow, okay? That whole entire AEW vlog will be up for tomorrow. So look for that. That was from the Boston show, the second show ever of AEW. And it looks like Finn just woke up because he's got a cold. He's got a cold, so now he's waking up right now because he slept most
shit
of the day
bomb.
Sick.
Joe, can you do commentary over the Kansas State brawl from the other night?
That's a good idea. I don't think I can air it on YouTube is the problem. But I could probably put up... I could probably put something up somewhere on some site and link it. On Patreon or something. Donnie M., thank you, man. Hey, Finn, come here. Are you okay? Do you need a drink? Is that why you woke up? You still sick? Come here, you look better. Are you not sick anymore? Come here. Would you wake up because you slept all day today and now you woke up? Yeah. Come here. Come here, come give me a hug.
What are you doing awake, you?
I guess sick. I feel better.
You feel better?
Yeah.
You feel better, but you're awake at 2 in the morning. That's the problem. You slept all day today because you were sick, but now you're not sick, and now you're awake. That's the problem. I'm just kidding. It's not that big a problem. Relax.
See?
Oh, maybe you're... Jesus, don't come near me.
I'm sick.
I know. So you're still sick. So why? Like,
yeah, because you make me sick.
I didn't make you sick. What are you talking about? You're going to make me sick. That's what's going to happen, is you're going to make me sick.
No, you feel better.
I feel fine. Yeah, I feel I feel better because I feel fine.
Yeah, and you're sick. I want to get you a
watch. Vince, yeah, I'll get that. Guys, I'll try to get that up for you. I'm going to upload it like in a minute, actually. It'll probably take hours to upload, to be honest, but it will be up. In fact, I'll premiere it so it premieres, so you guys can have fun with that. Well, probably while I'm watching Picard, you know? Just my take, you know? Put it on BitChute, Donnie. That's a good idea. I could put it on BitChute. The reaction to the LSU thing or whatever. Or not LSU, but the Kansas fight. My bad. What's up? I'll still kiss you even though you're sick.
You're going to get me sick, though.
Did you get the coronavirus? All right, guys. I'm going to, guess, head out and tuck him back in, figure out what's going on, get him some thin a drink, and watch Picard, and get that. I'll get that AEW thing up. So by noontime tomorrow, that whole thing will be up. All right? I'm going to try to make sure we get that. Finn got the same nose as me. Does he? Do you have my nose? Mm-hmm. Well, you kind of do have my nose. I guess you do have my nose. You kind of got my eyes a little bit. Your sister has my eyes, though. You got mommy's hair. You got a little cute face. You look like a mix between both of them. I don't even know who you look like. Reckless Jeff, what up, man? Ed's View. Hey, Black Lab, thank you so much for the Cronin virus. That's a good point. Thanks to Black... What are you doing? Thanks to Black Lab for the $69, man. Very much. Give me five. Yeah, give me a big five. Big one. A big, want to squeeze? Give me a big squeeze right on my shoulders, not my throat. What is this? Can I have this?
No, it's an egg.
It's an Eggman?
Yeah.
Wait a minute, look at Ray.
He has no arms and no legs.
He doesn't have arms or legs. Let's see, Ray. That's great. Look, there he is. I'm Mr. Eggman. Here I come, Mr. Eggman. Boom. Oh, he got me. You gotta go back to bed. What are you doing awake? Ow. Jesus, you hurt me there. That was too hard, you butt. What are you doing? Tickle you. Everybody can see kids. Look, I really have kids. They really exist. Joe, take care of Vin. Louis Money, what's up, man? What's up, everybody? All right. Good night. Say good night to everybody.
Night.
Right in the mic. Say good night, everybody.
Night.
Say, what's your favorite color?
Blue.
Blue? Really?
Yeah.
I never heard you say that. That's the first time. Awesome. Mine's green. Yo, good night, everybody. Junebug, what up, Junebug? Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, guys. Thanks to Black Lab for the... he's going to take home that digital championship tonight. And, I mean, luckily we know it's really my kid. You know, they all have my features. At least something of my feature. Right? All right, good night, everybody. Thank you so much. See you tomorrow. Yeah. Oh, no, you dropped Eggman. Go get him. You dropped Eggman. Go get Eggman. You're crawling on the ground. Thank you, guys. Good night, everybody.
I'm here.
All right, head upstairs. I'm going to come up. You want to piggyback?
Yeah, I need help to piggyback.
Whoa. Here, hop behind me and get a piggyback. Oh.
Whoa.
All right, let me end the stream here. I love you. All right. You want me to tuck you in? You want me to read your book? What book do you want to read? You want to read Bernstein Bear's book?
Sonic.
Or Spider-Man? Spider-Man book?
Sonic book.
Okay. Sonic book? All right, we'll look for a Sonic book. Find one.
It's up there.
All right, hop on my back. Let's go.
Wait.
Oh, we're going to go flying up the stairs.